State wins the Division I football championship.
Welcome to Frigid Bozeman, Montana, in the NCAA football championship. Tonight, in the first quarterfinal of the weekend, 2011 runner-up Sam Houston State, led by their all-time leading rusher, Timothy Flanders, takes on third-seeded Montana State, a team which will lean heavily on the arm and legs of Big Sky offensive MVP, Denarius McGee. It's Sam Houston State and Montana State coming up. Watching the NCAA FCS Football Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Welcome to Big Sky Country and a full house on hand as third seed Montana State is at home to take on Sam Houston State. Take a look at the bracket and what is next. We're at the bottom of it. And so far, Montana State and Sam Houston State ready to move on. The winner stays alive to face either Eastern Washington or at-large Illinois State out of the Missouri Valley. The loser heads home for the offseason. Welcome, everybody. Tom Hart alongside John Kangemi. We're here at Bozeman. Got a couple inches of snow last night. We expect upwards of four before we're finished tonight. And temperatures in the 20s. That's quite a rude welcome for the kids from Texas.
It might affect them. If it snows the way it did yesterday, Tom, it'll be difficult on these high-scoring offenses. But I want to take a look at the other side. I think the team that's playing this deep in the season, playing for championships, you're going to win with defense. And whoever plays better defense tonight just might win it.
Well, Sam Houston State plays great on both sides of the ball. They're led with an option offense. It has powered them to a 9-3 record, but after two early losses, they really had to catch fire to make it to the postseason. A lone late loss to Johnny Manziel and Texas A&M finished them with three losses, but number five in the country, 42 points a game, and one of the best defenses in the country. The biggest difference this year with the option of attack is Brian Bell, the quarterback, is a year older, and he's developed into a great passer.
And he's more experienced, and he feels comfortable within the pocket, throwing for over 2,000 yards. He's a son of a coach, so he understands the game. He's like an extension of the coaching staff out on the football field. 28 wins as a starter. That's a school record. He's the guy you want pulling the trigger for Sam Houston State.
And he can lean on a pretty good running back. Timothy Flanders, a Walter Payton Award finalist for the second straight season.
Well, the first part of this triple option offense starts with Flanders, number 20. He's a workhorse. He has 22 school records, over 100 yards last week against Cal Poly, eight times this season. He's the guy that gets it done on the ground.
And on the other side, Montana State. For the third straight year, conference champs for the third straight year, co-champions this year, which gave them an at-large berth. Their only loss came to the defending national champs out of Eastern Washington, number two in the nation, top 10 in both offense and defense. But would you believe they're led by a pair of Texans, starting with their quarterback out of Euless Trinity, Denarius McGee.
McGee's a guy that can get it done in the pocket, but with starting running back Cody Kirk not playing possibly till late in the first quarter, Denarius is going to have to use his legs. He might need to run it a little bit more, but he's a playmaker, a very dynamic quarterback, whether he's sitting in the pocket or he's stretching you on the outside.
Well, you can say the same about the talents on the defensive side. It's Jody Owens, a senior linebacker out of Mesquite, Texas.
One of the team leaders. He's a captain for this defense. He's decisive. He's very instinctive at that linebacker position. He has a great first step, and he'll have to tonight to stop this triple option attack.
It's Montana State out of the Big Sky Conference against Sam Houston State, coming straight out of Texas, and it should be a fun one tonight in the snow from Bozeman.
Introducing Droid DNA by HTC. It's not an upgrade to your phone, it's an upgrade to yourself.
Kate, will you marry me?
Yes.
Attention, he went to Jared.
Create your own one-of-a-kind ring at Jared this Friday through Sunday and receive Get Set in Diamonds rewards, up to $1,000 toward a beautiful diamond setting when you buy your diamond at Jared. Choose from thousands of diamonds and hundreds of settings.
Oh, Please return your fiance to her original upright position.
Get up to $1,000 reward at Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Welcome back, Sam. Houston State and Montana State. Now let's introduce you to the third member of our crew, Allison Williams.
Tom, I know some people are wondering how kids from a team in Texas will deal with the sub-30 temps here in Bozeman, but the Bearcats I talked to didn't seem worried about it. They said, ah, it's nothing. This is fun. But it is unfamiliar. This team has played 8 road games, none of them outside of the South. Head coach Willie Fritz said when they landed, a lot of them saw snow for the first time. Now, he didn't do anything to prepare them for the cold, but he did prepare them for the noise here. This close end zone at Bobcat Stadium can get pretty rowdy, so he piped in music, crowd noise into practice, worked on the silent counts. Look for not only the weather, but the crowd to be a factor.
Big home field advantage for the Bobcats. They've won 18 of their last 21 here in Bozeman. Sam Houston State won and elected to defer. The Montana State will receive in a full capacity crowd on hand here at Bobcat Stadium. You know, when Sam Houston State stepped off the charter last night, the flurries were already falling. And by the time they got to their hotel here in Bozeman, there was enough snow on the ground to build some snowmen and get their arms loose with some snowball fights.
Tom, I'm just glad you had a red SUV to be able to identify to get to the stadium today, because there was a lot of snow last night. We're expecting the weather to roll in a little bit later in this game, and it might affect the offenses. That's why I'm looking for which team's going to be able to make plays on special teams, which team is going to make that defensive stand to make a difference in this football game.
No shirts tonight? Chilly night here in Bozeman.
They didn't get the memo,
I guess not. And great to see a great crowd on hand here as well. Miguel Antonio, senior from Lovelady, Texas, will kick off. Sean Johnson and Everett Gilbert back to receive. Gilbert's second in school history with nearly 4,000 career all-purpose yards. And Antonio gets us started with a kick right to the goal line, and Gilbert wants to bring it out. Runs into his own man and gets down at the 10. Credit Michael Wade with a special teams tackle, and here's Denarius McGee, the junior quarterback.
And a lot of pressure on McGee tonight because he's without that starting running back, Cody Kirk, for the first part of this game. But he's very efficient from the pocket, almost 3,000 yards on the season throwing it. But it's running the football tonight where he's going to make the biggest difference. He's a playmaker, so watch for Darius to get out on the edge, try to make up some of that lack of running ability with Cody Kirk out of the football game. A lot of pressure on number 9 tonight.
Last week against Stony Brook, he accounted for 82% of the Bobcats' offense. They fake the end around, and he throws on first down to Sean Johnson, who's got room. And Johnson, with a beautiful cutback, carries it all the way to the 34-yard line. Andrew Weaver finally chases him down after a gain of 23.
Beautiful play action by McGee. Watch the little play action. He moves the pocket, and that's going to be a key tonight, making decisions, moving the pocket, so the pressure of Sam Houston State cannot affect the pocket. Watch Denarius to roll out and move the pocket a little bit tonight.
Lorenzo Davis is now at running back for Montana State. They're without their starter, Cody Kirk, for now. And Davis carries it straight ahead to pick up a few, gain of 4, brought down by Darnell Taylor. Denarius McGee has thrown a touchdown pass in 36 of the last 37 games. He's from Texas Power Trinity High School in Euless and a Big Sky offensive MVP this season.
And Tom, the weather really doesn't affect Denarius. His head coach Rob Ash says he's a great bad weather quarterback, so as the weather, if it does come later in this game, shouldn't affect number 9.
Davis still in the backfield at running back. McGee to throw, and the slant is incomplete. Trying to find Brian Flotketter. Coverage by Dak Swanson, who knocked it away. Big receivers matched up against very talented Sam Houston State corners.
And that's a really something to watch on the outside. Tanner Bleskin and Brian Flotketter on the outside, 6'2 and 6'3 respectively. They're going to try to line those guys up in tandem, try to run some picks, some hooks, quick slants like you just saw on second down.
Third and 6 now for the Bobcats. Here comes an extra man. Sam Houston State blitzes nonstop, and the deep ball is incomplete. Working to the short side of the field, John Ellis was the intended receiver. The scouting report on the Bearcats of Sam Houston State say that they will blitz and then blitz some more.
They're not afraid to pressure the pocket, and they're not afraid to put guys out on an island. Like you just saw Snead, four. He's going to be in man-to-man coverage close to 50% of the time tonight, and that means the Bearcats defensively are going to try to attack McGee in the pocket.
Rory Perez to kick it off to Trey Diller, senior out of Spring, Texas. Perez averages 41 yards a punt. Fair catch asked for and taken near the 28. 35-yard punt. Brian Bell is the option quarterback for Sam Houston State, son of a coach, and he's turned into a quality passer.
He really has. He's become an accurate thrower of the football. He's on time with his passes. He's able to move the pocket because of his athleticism, but his bread and butter is this triple option. So if they get the running going again with Flanders and Sincere and some quarterback running as well, then you're going to see Brian Bell be able to open up the passing game. So he can do it both for the Bearcats.
Bell threw for 285 yards, but three picks against Baylor. Sacked three times that game. Only sacked four times all year. Timothy Flanders with the carry on first down out of this option attack. Forced out of bounds by Darius Jones. Let's meet the impact players for the Bearcats of Sam Houston State.
Well, you just got to see Timothy Flanders on that first run. He's the workhorse. It all starts with him. But on the outside, Trey Diller, he'll play all over the football field, and he's got that vertical to go up and get it. And Nelson on the outside, very explosive, seven touchdowns. He's the guy that can stretch the field vertically.
Out of the pistol now with Flanders behind Bell. They disguise everything well with motion, and officials stop the play before the snap can get off. A rematch of a quarterfinal last year, won by Sam Houston State in a game in Huntsville, Texas, in chilly conditions, but no snow on the ground last year in Texas. Henry Winberg, our official.
Game clock to 13:26.
It's a great environment here, Tom, at Bobcat Stadium. They pack them in, and they just redid the end zone to our right, so a lot more fans can come in, and it gets noisy in here early in this football game.
Second and six for Sam Houston State. Flanders the lone back. Nice cut to the outside, and Flanders near the marker for the first down, needed to get to the 38. Jody Owens, Big Sky defensive MVP with the stop, and that'll be enough for a fresh set of downs.
Nice cut by the running back, but Caleb Hobson, one of those big tackles, 6'6", 300 pounds. He can really seal you off, and that's exactly what he did for the offense on that off-tackle play.
Flanders coming off of a 100-yard performance last week against Cal Poly on just 17 carries. First runner to get 100 yards against Cal Poly in a span of 18 games against a stout defense. Quarterback keeps it this time. Bell trying to get to the perimeter, nowhere to go. Stephen Bethley, but a flag on the play, likely holding against the Bearcats, and the tight end TJ Jones.
Great speed that time by the free safety, Stephen Bethley, coming from that middle of the field.
Holding, offense, number 83. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
Tight ends here are primarily blocking tight ends for Sam Houston State.
Yeah, it may have been TJ Jones on the outside, 83, who gets a hand up, and he's definitely tackling Joe Fuller on the edge. And there's Bethley to come up and make the tackle, but the holding was at the point of attack.
Except the penalty, this will bring up a first and 20 now. Flanders again, hit in the backfield, and Flanders thrown for a loss. Jody Owens, the first man there, and he bends them back. All-America and conference defensive MVP against a two-time Southland Conference Player of the Year.
Tom, we talked about Jody in the open, how instinctive he is, and now he has a great first step so he can fight the initial block and then get in the backfield to make a tackle for a loss. Huge play for this defense on first down. He's able to shed the block and then find Flanders.
Loss of a couple, second and 22. Bell changes the play at the line in front of a loud crowd here on the road. Play clock of four, and here's the option again. Flanders hustles his way out of bounds, picks up two, chased out by Cole Moore, sophomore from Palo Alto, California. Here's some impact players in the defensive side of the ball for the Bobcats of Montana State.
Well, Tom, other than Jody Owens, they have some people that can get after the quarterback in Shrybrice and Moiaku Ola. They can get after the quarterback. Caleb's had a sack in every football game that he's played, and Moiaku Ola, he has a tall task of being able to go downhill tonight, but also to try to contain that speed of Sam Houston State.
And of course, Jody Owens, who's already been in on plays. Third and long. Pressure coming. Bell steps away. Buys time and incomplete. And the defense stands. Chance Nelson, the intended receiver.
Tom, I talked about defensive pressure in the open. It might be the difference. Both of these teams can score at a high rate, but with a cold night, it might even get worse with wind and weather and snow. Which defense is going to come up and win the battle of field position to tee their offense up?
Matt Foster from Melbourne, Australia, the punter from down under, to kick it away to Sean Johnson. Johnson had a big punt return last week against Stony Brook. That sounded like a cold kick. And he'll take a Bearcat hop and be down inside the 20, about the 18. 54-yard punt that time from Foster. Fantastic atmosphere here in Bozeman with a full house at Bobcat Stadium.
The Heisman Trophy presentation tomorrow at 8 on ESPN.
Hey, Cam, thanks a lot for coming to school today.
No problem, Nate.
I promise to exercise and eat right.
Don't forget 60 minutes of play a day, right?
And I'll grow up to be big and strong like you.
Absolutely.
I'm playing the NFL.
Yes, sir.
I'm drafted number one.
Maybe.
Become the starting quarterback of the Panthers.
Okay.
You can be my backup.
Excuse me?
And make Panthers fans forget about you.
What?
And become your mom's favorite player.
Whoa.
I'm just loosening my arm.
One car travels towards an intersection with wipers that streak and clog, while another travels towards the same intersection with wiper blades that don't let them see clearly. But between them, the Michelin Man with new Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades. A revolution in wiper blade technology, combining SmartFlex construction for superior windshield contact with proven hybrid blade design for clog-free performance in rain, ice, and snow, helping you steer clear for the road ahead. New Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades, a better way forward.
Cold. I took DayQuil, but I still have a runny nose.
DayQuil doesn't treat that.
Huh?
Alka-Seltzer Plus rushes relief to all your worst cold symptoms, plus it relieves your runny nose.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. That's the cold truth.
The NCAA FCS Football Championship is presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We'll pick you up. And in part by the Capital One Cup, recognizing the best in men's and women's college sports. Big Sky Country here in Bozeman. Those are the Bridgers, and the ski area opened up just today. Kept my partner John Congemi busy. And it was a busy week last week for this Denarius McGee-led team out of Montana State. Home against Stony Brook after a first-round bye. Their defense held to a field goal on the first series, and then they struck deep. A 69-yard touchdown pass from McGee to Tanner Bleskin in the first quarter. They never trailed. And stormed the field afterwards, hosting playoff games for the first time since 1984. And head coach Rob Ash, Cornell product, former quarterback, and former Drake head coach. He's the winningest head coach at three different schools in the 2011 Liberty Mutual FCS Coach of the Year.
Well, he told us yesterday how important it would be to try to be able to run the football against the pressure that Sam Houston State can cause at the line of scrimmage. So they're going to try to do that and test that early against this defense.
Sean Johnson in at running back. They've gone to their second and third string running backs to start this game tonight. And for more on where Cody Kirk is, let's check in once again with Allison Williams.
Yeah, Tom, for now he is on the sidelines. It's been touch and go with him all week after spraining his MCL in the game last week against Stony Brook. Now, he does have his knee taped and with a brace on it, but I was watching him in warmups. He looked good. He was making all his cuts. He was sprinting along the sideline during the last timeout. So we'll keep an eye on him and see if and when he gets involved. We expect that he will at some point, Tom.
All right, thanks, Allison. Tied for first in school history with 29 career touchdowns. And he's a power back. Now Orenzo Davis, more perimeter-oriented, is in the game for Montana State. McGee hesitates. Now he takes off. And he makes it up to the 29-yard line before Jesse Beauchamp brings him down.
And that's the one thing you want to have a good decision in the pocket. If you decide to pull the football down and run it, you have to be decisive and you have to make a good quick decision. And now you're going to get Cody Kirk in the game on third and medium for the Bobcats.
Kirk has 8 of his school's last 11 100-yard rush games. This junior from Frenchtown, Montana. Trey Robinson, the Nebraska transfer, joins him in the backfield. Kirk will block. McGee turns around. He has some green in front of him. And McGee steps up and throws. Picked off right at the sideline. And they're going to rule inbounds. 26th takeaway of the season for the Bearcats. And Kenneth Jenkins' first interception of the season.
And that's one Daenerys would like to have back. Just tried to force the football after making a great escape in his own backfield. He's going to escape the initial pressure, but right here, just go out of bounds or throw it out of bounds, because this is a team that loves to take the football away. You mentioned it. That's the 26th takeaway for this defense, and you win the battle of field position. Great concentration on the sideline, getting that foot in. The crowd doesn't like it.
Just showed it on the big board here. Postseason replay is in effect, the FCS level. First and 10, Timothy Flanders at tailback. Quarterback will keep it. This is Richard Sincere, the Wild Bobcat quarterback, comes in to run the option. Had a great game last year against Montana State, ran for 160.
And that's the changeup you get with Sam Houston State on offense. Sincere will go in that pistol. He'll go in shotgun and start as the Wildcat quarterback because he's such a great open field runner. Head coach Willie Fritz told us during the week they want to get at least 10 touches to Sincere out of that position.
Ryan Bell back in at quarterback. Sincere, his normal spot, bottom of the formation, and a wideout. Bell rolls that direction, has time, and finds Sincere. Caught at the 18. Sincere makes a move, and he's inside the 5. A beautiful catch and run from Bell to Sincere. Flowers finally brings him down after a gain of 38.
And it's all possible, Tom, because of Brian Bell. He's become a better passer, and watch him throw the wide receiver open. This is just a throw behind. It was good coverage initially by Jones, the cornerback. But Bell threw the football behind purposely to throw his receiver open in Sincere and let his athlete in open field make a big play.
Now they split Bell out, and Flanders will take the direct snap. 17 touchdowns in the season for the running back Flanders. It's all him, left side. And he scrambles his way to the goal line, ruled down just outside of the end zone. They're going to mark it back at the 2. Great balance by Flanders, 5'9", 210 pounds out of Midwest City, Oklahoma. He started his college career at Kansas State.
And I wouldn't be shocked at all if number 20 gets that football again inside the 5-yard line. He's a workhorse. He gets those shoulders square, and he runs behind his pad so well. I would expect him to get the football here on 2nd and goal.
Bell back out of the shotgun. Flanders changes direction. Stood up at the line of scrimmage. Nothing doing, straight ahead. Jody Owens and Cole Moore stop him. 3rd and goal.
Terrific defensive stand by Montana State, but I believe Flanders might have went in the wrong direction. Looked like Brian Bell wanted to hand it to him one way, and Flanders was on the other side.
Sincere will line up at quarterback in front of Flanders. Play clock at three and a flag before they get it off. That was going to be an option with Sincere, but a false start for the Bearcats will back him up.
False start, 88 on the offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
KJ Williams, the tight end, moved.
And we mentioned how loud it can get at that end of the stadium.
They just added 7,200 seats in that end zone, the south end zone, before the start of the season. And those rowdy students in the band giving an earful. The Sam Houston State Bearcats. They're used to playing on the road. Only three home games this season for the Bearcats.
And now you have to let your athletic quarterback maybe move the pocket to the wide side of the field.
Bell back in at quarterback. He'll do just that and want to throw to the end zone. Out route incomplete. Trey Diller, the intended receiver. Flowers had the coverage, and what a huge, huge defensive stand for Montana State.
Tom, enormous defensive stand. You give the football up in great field position for Sam Houston State that's averaging over 40 points a game, and now you're going to, three times in a row inside the 5-yard line, you come up big, and now you allow an opportunity just for a field goal.
Miguel Antonio has hit on 79% of his field goals this season. And Sam Houston State holds the early lead on a 24-yard field goal. The senior from Lovelady, Texas. Bearcats had a 38-yard pass and run to Sincere that set him up with first and goal after this takeaway, but they couldn't find the end zone. A field goal to start. 3-0 Bearcats.
San Diego State, football.
USC, soccer.
Quincy University, volleyball.
At Enterprise Rent-A-Car, we hire more new college graduates every year than any other company.
And many of us played college sports, too.
Like me.
Like me.
And me.
Now we're all on the same team. Yours.
Enterprise is proud to be an official corporate partner of the NCAA.
Teamwork. Let us show you what that means.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
To win the Capital One Cup and be the best in men's and women's college sports, you gotta lay it all on the line. Every play, every game, in every sport. Teams are battling it out for NCAA Division I championships, $400,000 in student-athlete scholarships, and the Capital One Cup trophy. More metal for the case. Follow your school and check the standings at CapitalOneCup.com to see who will win the Capital One Cup.
Droid DNA augmentation initiated. Neural speeds increasing to 4G LTE. Brain upgrading to a quad-core processor. Predictive intelligence with Google Now complete.
Introducing Droid DNA by HTC. It's not an upgrade to your phone. It's an upgrade to yourself.
Welcome back to Bozeman. 3-0 Sam Houston State with the lead over 3-seed Montana State. These teams met in the semifinal in Huntsville, Texas last year. A game that was close. It turned on an 82-yard kickoff return touchdown. And the Bearcats rattled off 29 unanswered points in a 49-13 victory. Tim Flanders had a school record 287 yards and a touchdown. All the breaks went the Bearcats' way, and Flanders and Sincere both had monster days for Sam Houston State. That propelled him to the national championship game under head coach Willie Fritz. His third season at Sam Houston State, came over from Central Missouri in Warrensburg. Before that, a couple of junior college national championships at Blinn Junior College. We had a quarterback, talk about a dual threat, by the guy, a guy by the name of Michael Bishop, went on to star Kansas State, of course. Also a high school coach, he's had success at every level.
And Willie Fritz, he knows how to win. 29-9 is his record, and it's a tough environment he brings his Bearcats into tonight, but they've been able to get the turnover, their 26th of the season, and turn it into 3 points and take a lead. And that's what Sam Houston State needed to do coming on the road. You want to score first, and you want to be able to establish something. So you get some points out of a turnover, and now you get your defense and that pressure back on the football field.
Everett Gilbert back to receive this kick from Miguel Antonio. A lot of Texans on the field, both sides, including some Bobcats. Gilbert is from Rockwall, Texas. From the two, this is Sean Johnson. Bottled up. Changes his mind. Here he goes. Whoa, leveled at the 24. A big pop will take down Johnson. Kenneth Jenkins laid him out. And there's a flag all the way back at the 34-yard line. Will be offsides on Sam Houston State. We may do this again.
Kenneth Jenkins with the big hit, but as you said, a flag back at the 35-yard line may bring this one back.
Offsides on a kicking team. 5-yard penalty tacked on from the end of the run. First down, Montana State.
Sean Johnson, meet Kenneth Jenkins.
Looked like he slid right into him, but that's a de-cleater. Just a great physical play on special teams by Kenneth Jenkins, the safety.
Jenkins had the interception on the previous drive. Now he comes up with a special team stop. And Sam Houston State may have had to settle for a field goal. But early on, the momentum seems to be with the visitors. Lorenzo Davis and Trey Robinson, full house, backfield for Montana State. This is Davis. One of the concerns with having Lorenzo Davis in the game is that he's perimeter-oriented, and they don't expect to find a lot of success on the perimeter against the speed of Sam Houston State.
Well, if they're gonna have some success on offense, they're gonna have to get some rushing yards from their quarterback, and that's from McGee. He's gonna have to take the place of Cody Kirk. And then they're going to have to stop the big play. You've already seen the interception turn into 3 points. You have to create positive plays if you're Montana State and stay away from the turnovers.
Denarius McGee, the quarterback, one of 20. Walter Payton Award semifinalist, player of the year in the FCS. Long throw complete to John Ellis, and he scoots by a guy. And Ellis takes it to the 47, and Kenneth Jenkins forks it out of bounds. How did he get free on the edge? A gain of 19 for Ellis.
And Tom, if there's one guy that's elusive in this pass game for Montana State, it's John Ellis. He has dependable hands, but he's the speedster. He can make you miss in space, and it's McGee's job to try to get John Ellis that ball out quickly in space.
Slid by the safety, Robert Shaw. They fake the jet sweep and they give straight ahead to Lorenzo Davis, and he crosses midfield. And now impact players for the Bobcats of Montana State.
Well, we mentioned Cody Kirk. He was the starter. He's going to impact this offense one way or another. Hopefully, he'll be able to get on the football field. But if he doesn't, Davis is the guy with great speed. He needs to run north and south. No U-turns on the outside. And Bleskin on the outside, one of those tall receivers that matches up well on the Sam Houston State corners.
Kirk injured left knee, was on the field for one play, used just to pick up the blitz and block. Four wide, they let it go complete, just shy of the sticks, and those forward progress gives it to him. Brian Flodketter, sophomore from Laurel, Montana, had a career high 7 catches against their rivals from Missoula. Second and inches. Nope, they give him the first down.
And Tom, that's part of the plan offensively for the Bobcats. We talked with offensive coordinator Kevin McGivin. They want to attack the short side of the field and not really test the arm strength of McGee to the wide side because of the speed of the defensive secondary of Sam Houston State.
26 takeaways on the season. They want their opponent to have to throw the ball. Johnson and Davis in the backfield, and a timeout used by the Bobcats.
Timeout, Montana State. First timeout.
One loss on the season from Montana State. 11-1 coming into this home game to try and stay alive against Sam Houston State.
Purchase championship merchandise tonight from the NCAA.
The holidays are here, and that means falling prices at Rent-A-Center. Right now, get a Samsung 43-inch plasma TV or a 5-piece bedroom set. Your choice, just $780. And with the Rack Flex plan, everyone's pre-approved for 90 days, same as cash.
What'd you win now?
Golden water cooler. Got it for a joke I told in the break room.
What was the joke?
It was...
It's about me, wasn't it?
Yes.
At least keep it on my desk?
No.
I wish my patients could see what I see. That over time, having high cholesterol and any of these risk factors can put them at increased risk for plaque buildup in their arteries. So it's even more important to lower their cholesterol. And that's why when diet and exercise alone aren't enough, I prescribe Crestor. In a clinical trial versus Lipitor, Crestor got more high-risk patients' bad cholesterol to a goal of under 100.
Crestor is not right for everyone, like people with liver disease or women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. Tell your doctor about other medicines you're taking. Call your doctor right away if you have muscle pain or weakness, feel unusually tired, have loss of appetite, upper belly pain, dark urine, or yellowing of skin or eyes. These could be signs of rare but serious side effects.
Is your cholesterol at goal? Talk to your doctor about Crestor.
If you can't afford your medication, AstraZeneca may be able to help.
Chris Cotter in our college football studios in Bristol. We've got an NBA doubleheader going on right now over on ESPN. Sixers and Celtics right now, with the Sixers up by 5 in the third quarter. And then Lakers and Thunder are coming your way from OKC immediately to follow over on ESPN. Now back to Bozeman.
All right, thanks, Chris. 3-0, Sam Houston State leads Montana State here. 4:01 to go in the first quarter as we revisit the brackets. I made a mistake earlier. I said that Eastern Washington, the defending national champs, that would be the guys from North Dakota State. They're the number one seed, and they have an option attack opposite them tomorrow in Wofford. Old Dominion and Georgia Southern Saturday, noon on ESPN. Another option attack in Georgia Southern. What does that have to do with Sam Houston State and Montana State? Well, knowing that so many good teams in the FCS run the option, Montana State spent a lot of time this offseason preparing for it. Not necessarily practicing against it, but learning what they needed to do to slow it down. They're on offense now, and McGee trying to set up a little wide receiver screen to Trey Robinson, and the Nebraska transfer fights to get back to the line of scrimmage. Kenneth Jenkins with the play defensively for Sam Houston State.
Tom, a great example of the team speed defensively for Sam Houston State. They're stretching, trying to go sideline to sideline as Montana State, but the team speed, Kenneth Jenkins, again, coming from the secondary, he's the guy that's going to creep down with Darnell Taylor and play close to the line of scrimmage on first and second down.
Quarterback's going to keep it, Denarius McGee. Great block on the edge, and McGee makes a move inside the 25. Still going, and he rumbles inside the 10. Forbes Baggett finally brings him down. A motivated gain of 33 for Denarius McGee.
Tom, we talked about one of the keys for Montana State would be to get the quarterback, Denarius McGee, involved in the running game to make up for Cody Kirk, the starter at tailback. This time he shows you great balance, good vision on the outside, and he didn't want to go down that easily. He gets the ball around the 11-yard line, so a nice chunk yardage play by the quarterback, Denarius McGee.
Longest run of the season for McGee, who last week against Stony Brook accounted for 82% of the Bobcats' offense. And an offensively challenged game for Montana State. Came away with a 16-10 victory thanks to their defense.
And Tom, this is an offense that scores close to 35 points a game. So now that they're in the red zone where they've been fairly efficient all year, look for the quarterback to be impactful.
Zone read, McGee wants to throw. Pressured now, got a man! Right through the hands of Lorenzo Davis. Davis had leaked out of the backfield. And by the time McGee found him, did he throw it too hard?
Well, he had to. There was a defensive back closing, but he has him right now. But that's a good job of recognizing by Kenneth Jenkins to get off of Trey Robinson and get his eyes in attention to Lorenzo Davis. That ball, you catch it 9 times out of 10, but with a cold night, it's tough to react to it.
26 sacks on the season for Sam Houston State. Fake the sweep again, and McGee will take off. Rumbles to the five. Darnell Taylor with the stop for the Bearcats. Darnell Taylor came into this game with 91 tackles on the season. He had 128 last year. The two-time Southland Conference Defensive Player of the Year out of Mesquite High School. Third and five. They can get a first down by making it to the one.
Bleskin one-on-one to the short side. You may try it there.
McGee looks back. Tied in with the one-handed grab. Flag on the play. It was a right tackle, Stephen Foster, tackle eligible, but this one might be coming back.
Illegal touching. Offense number 61. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Third down.
He's on the end and uncovered.
It looks like Foster was on the end of the line of scrimmage. He's going to be down here in Foster, but it looks like he's going to block down and go like it's going to be a rollout to the right side. He's going to make a heck of a one-handed catch on the outside, but the linesman right on it calls illegal touching. It looked like Bleskin was covered. He was covered up on the outside by Bleskin, and that was the problem.
We knew Montana State would have a few wrinkles here tonight, and they put in a few wrinkles over the last couple of weeks. The problem is they've had a short week to prepare.
And that was one of the wrinkles that we were going to see from Coach Ash, but now he's still in third down situation inside the red zone, so you have to rely on your quarterback, McGee, to make a play. But that was one athletic play by Stephen Foster.
Well, last year, Foster was a second-team All-Conference tight end. They moved him to tackle this year. And he was a second-team All-Conference tackle.
Montana State head coach is challenging the ruling on the play of a forward pass. The play is under further review.
So if it's a lateral, it would stand. If it was there is no such thing as a lateral. If it's a backwards pass.
Well, the catch was amazing. Let's see. The ball's on the 6-yard line. Now, he's covered up on the outside by Tanner Bleskin. But let's see if the ball travels backwards. Now you're going to see McGee go to his right. He gets rid of the ball around the 13-yard line, and that ball's caught around the 11-yard line. So it's a forward pass. This is just an outstanding catch by a guy that's 6'5", 270 pounds, and he knows where the end zone is, and a great effort to get there. But the offensive
the
set
on the field is confirmed. There's a timeout charged to Montana State. That'll be their second timeout.
And they lose their only challenge after losing the timeout as well. You know, instant replay in effect for the postseason, something new for everybody, but you can't blame them. That's the kind of challenge.
Got to take a shot, Tom,
yeah.
Right?
What a difference it makes. Well, the most revered award in college football will be presented Saturday on ESPN. Who will join one of the game's most exclusive fraternities? The Heisman Trophy presentation Saturday at 8 on ESPN. The Sam Houston State team facing a dual threat quarterback in Denarius McGee. They also faced a pretty good dual threat quarterback last game of the regular season. A kid by the name of Johnny Manziel from Texas A&M.
Yeah, he's pretty good.
So backed up now, 3rd and 10. Remember, Montana State can still gain a fresh set of downs by making it to the 1-yard line. Pressure coming. McGee wants to take off, and he scrambles inside the 5. Jarrett Brown trips him up.
And Tom, before this night's over, Denarius McGee is going to be impactful running the football because there are lanes there with so much pressure coming from Sam Houston State. It's coming up the field, and they're creating running lanes for the athletic quarterback.
Missed opportunity for Montana State after the illegal touching, and on to attempt the tip shot field goal will be Rory Perez. 22-yard attempt. Play clock ran out.
Delay game. Offense. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Not the worst thing in the world for Perez. He hasn't missed inside 30 this year. And the wind doesn't seem to be an issue yet, although that may change.
No, the only issue is that Sam Houston State on special teams, they've blocked kicks 6 times this year, and usually up the middle is where the pressure comes from.
12 over the last 2 years. And that one goes in over in through the uprights, tied at 3 near the end of the first quarter. Denarius McGee does a little bit of everything for Montana State, and he moves the chain.
He's done a nice job in the pocket, standing tall, being accurate with the football, but rushing the football is where he's been able to pick up the slack for Cody Kirk, who's been out with an MCL injury that he suffered last week. 4 rushes for 51 yards. He had the long there of 33. And I think before the night is over, he's going to be able to run it just as effectively as he throws it from the pocket.
Ran for 75 yards last week against Stony Brook, the leading rusher in the game for Montana State. 3 of 4 through the air last drive. Moved the chains twice by throwing the ball. He completes on the season 67% of his passes.
Well, Tom, he's a guy that has good fundamentals, but he's a playmaker, and they need him to pick up the slack in the running game. So there's going to be some design calls for McGee to rush the football. But he's still, when he's on the move, he's a dangerous guy throwing the football because he's disciplined with his eyes. He can keep his eyes down the field and make a big play in the passing game as well.
Trey Diller back to receive for Sam Houston State, along with Keyshawn Hill. A.J. Silva, freshman from Sparks, Nevada, puts it in the air. Hill wants to bring it out. Past the 20. And let's take a look at some keys for the Bearcats of Sam Houston State.
Well, they're multiple on offense, and they need to really spread it around offensively. It all starts with the quarterback, but you have to get Bell, the quarterback, and Timothy Flanders and Richard Sincere all involved, and then force turnovers with all that pressure they bring on the defensive side. We've seen the interception already tonight with Kenneth Jenkins coming up with an interception, but that's what they need to do to shorten the field for this offense in this triple option.
Injured player on special teams is Mike Littleton, senior from Galveston, Texas. Backup weak safety. And the athletic training staff giving him a nice long look. Well, an eventful first quarter with only 6 points to show for it, but it's kind of the MO for both defenses over the last couple of games, especially for Montana State. Bend but don't break.
And it has to be. If you can get this deep, trying to win a championship with only 8 teams remaining, you're going to have to make impactful plays on defense. And I think both of these teams can do that tonight.
Guys from Sam Houston State, Huntsville, Texas, not used to this cold. They got to their hotel last night and promptly had a snowball fight, built snowmen.
There was plenty of it to go around, that's for sure, last night.
Warm weather throughout the South versus what we have here. Today in Huntsville, it was 71 degrees, and it felt like 71. Here, 29, feels like it's in the teens. Later tonight, they expect upwards of 4 inches of snow, and obviously even more up in the mountain ranges. Keyshawn Hill and Timothy Flanders in the backfield joining Richard Sincere. Flanders, right side. Trying to strip the ball away was Stephen Bethley. And they bring Flanders down after a pickup of 7.
Well, the good news for Montana State is that running back Timothy Flanders has been relatively quiet rushing the football. Only 19 yards on 7 attempts. So if that's one aspect of this triple option you need to stop, you have to stop a guy that's averaging over 6 yards per carry coming into this game.
Flanders, a former Kansas State Wildcat. Bell to throw. Caught! First down, Bearcats, and Trey Diller, the Wofford transfer. Diller was on the scout team, made play after play after play. They said, we got to play this kid.
Boy, nice route, crisp route, and great timing from the pocket from Brian Bell. Just a strike on the outside, short side corner route, and he gets inside and then back outside, and the numbers do not lie. Trey Diller leads the team in receptions. He's one of those guys that can high point the ball but get crisp in and out of his routes.
Amy Hill faces former teammates of Terriers from Wofford in the postseason if Sam Houston State can stay alive. One quarter in the books in Bozeman. It's been a fun one already. We're locked at three.
For more than 75 years, one award has been synonymous with excellence. Tomorrow, a new name will be forever linked to college football's highest honor. The Heisman Trophy presentation presented by Nissan, tomorrow at 8 on ESPN.
What can you experience in a seat? Inspiration. Great power. Iconic design. Exhilarating performance.
Once again has created Lamar history.
And once in a great while, all of the above. Take your seat in the incomparable Audi A8. Take advantage of exceptional values on the Audi A8 during the Season of Audi event.
Introducing Droid DNA by HTC. It's not an upgrade to your phone, it's an upgrade to yourself.
Everyone deserves the gift of all-day pain relief. This season, discover Aleve. All-day pain relief with just two pills.
Clay Matthews is turning the NFL upside down. Turn your world upside down with Gillette Fusion Pro Glide, because you can shave against the grain with comfort with our thinnest blades. Our most comfortable shave or twice your money back. Gillette, the best a man can get.
Hey, guys. What are you doing?
We're going to have lunch together.
What are you having?
Oh, well, I only had this one.
I'll split it with Sally.
Yeah, we'll just share it.
Get your own Subway steak melt, like the steak and bacon melt. Subway, eat fresh.
You're watching the NCAA FCS Football Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Nice to have a four-wheel drive in Bozeman last couple of days. Sam
Houston State.
Beautiful ride. Third seed of Montana State tied at three. That guy's warm. It's a Bearcat. Maybe a Bobcat. You look at the first quarter stats in this cap fight. 104 yards so far from Montana State, led by their quarterback, and averaging better than 7 yards a carry. Sam Houston State is the team that came in with a predominant rushing attack, however, came into this game seventh in the nation, 274 yards a game on the ground.
And I like the way Brian Bell throws the football on time in that first quarter. Both quarterbacks have done a nice job.
Junior from China Spring, Texas, where he played for his father, Mark. And he hands it off for a big gain. Near side and still going is Flanders. Timothy Flanders hangs a U-turn and finally goes down at the 25-yard line. James Andrews with the stop for Montana State. Pickup of 27 for Flanders.
And that's the guy, if you're Montana State, you need to stop. Timothy Flanders, once he gets out in the open space, he can break a big play. That time he rips one off for 27, made that U-turn, Tom, around the 20 and lost a couple yards. But the two-time player of the year, they've been able to stop him so far. But on that gain, he gets outside for 27.
He only had 19 yards in the game prior to that run. First and 10, Bearcats, Flanders again. And he lost his balance and got popped at the same time. No gain after the hit by Darius Jones. Jones is another one of the Texas kids on this Montana State roster. They've got a ton of them. And who do they have to thank for that? A former Montana Grizzly. Former assistant coach Justin Gaines played his college ball in Missoula. He's now coaching at North Texas State. But as a Texas native, he went down there and opened up the pipeline to the Lone Star State, and they are loaded with Texans.
Right now, you want to attack man-to-man. You've got Dillard down at the bottom.
Bell to throw. Deep ball overthrown. Trey Diller is the intended receiver. Jones with the coverage.
And I like the opportunity of taking a shot with the receiver man-to-man down here. Just going to try to split the defense and let your quarterback throw you open. So you split the defense and you get behind Jones, but the ball was just a little bit overthrown. If it's thrown a touch earlier and to the inside, I think Diller would have been able to adjust to the football.
Third and 10. They've been in third and long seemingly all night. Bell delivers it on time and on the money to Chance Nelson. And a Bearcat first down.
Brian Bell again throwing the football on time. You mentioned it, Tom. I like his decision making. He's very crisp with the football, and he's accurate with the football. And especially when you want to get down in the red zone, take the easy throw. There was a deep throw that he could have forced the football there, but he knows when it's third and 10, you don't need the touchdown. Move the change and stay on the field.
That was the first third down conversion of the night for either team. Bell's thrown for 2,100 yards in the season coming in, completing 62% of his passes. TJ Jones in motion. Flanders hit behind the line by Jody Owens. And you mentioned it early about the AFCA All-American, the Big Sky Defensive MVP. He's got fantastic football instincts.
He really does. A great first step where he's able to elude pressure, elude a block, feel which way he wants to go, and mirror the running back. And that's what Jody Owens did right there. He was able to elude the block of TJ Jones in the middle of the football field, feel the back, and slide with those quick feet to make the tackle.
12 and a half tackles for loss on the season. Fourth tackle tonight for Owens. They load up the backfield, go with the option. Quarterback will keep it. Sincere. Sincere is in. Touchdown, Sam Houston State. Sincere, the ball carrier. The Wild Bearcat pays off on a 12-yard rush by the junior from Galveston.
Tom, if there's one edge that Sam Houston State possesses, it's speed. If you're not going to get bad weather and you have good footing, you can get on the edge and use your speed against Montana State's defense. Richard Sincere, only 5'10", he made himself small around the 10-yard line and gets in for six.
Montana State coaches told us they haven't faced an option attack like this, even though they prepared for it throughout the offseason. The Wild Bearcat pays off, and Richard Sincere with his fourth rushing touchdown of the season. Sam Houston State back in front.
Guys?
He'll be fine.
More people are leaving BMW, Mercedes, and Lexus for Audi than ever before. Take advantage of exceptional values during the Season of Audi event.
To win the Capital One Cup and be the best in men's and women's college sports, you gotta lay it all on the line. Every play, every game, in every sport. Teams are battling it out for NCAA Division I championships, $400,000 in student-athlete scholarships, and the Capital One Cup trophy. More metal for the case. Follow your school and check the standings at CapitalOneCup.com to see who will win the Capital One Cup.
State Tom Hartwood, John Kangemi, and Richard Sincere had a huge game last year in the semis against Montana State. He's coming up big here tonight. 12-yard touchdown run. He also set up their first score, which was a field goal. A play, 79-yard drive. 3:20 off the clock.
And they were able to mix in the run and the pass. First, it was Brian Bell on the outside to Trey Diller for 21 yards. And then the workhorse, Timothy Flanders, he goes for 27, his longest run on the evening. And he was able to get outside and get into the open space and set up the Wildcat, the Bearcat, in the red zone. Richard Sincere goes in from 12 yards. So it was a nice combination of Brian Bell throwing the football and getting the playmakers, Flanders and Sincere, involved in this offense.
Could be Wildcat with a K, I suppose.
I guess so.
Gal Antonio set to kick it away.
Now you'd like to answer, Tom, with special teams. You'd like to get a big return to get this crowd back into the football game.
Everett Gilbert from the four. And he takes it out to the 20. Montana State comes into the postseason a bye week early. They're the 3 seed overall. And the winner of this one gets 2 seed Eastern Washington or Illinois State out of the Missouri Valley Conference. They play tomorrow night on ESPN3. Should be a fun one. Old Dominion and Georgia Southern from Norfolk tomorrow at noon on ESPN. And the defending champs from North Dakota State draw Wofford out of the SoCon.
Always fun time of year when you're playing for a championship.
20 teams in the postseason. They expand next year to 24. Cody Kirk is in the game at tailback for Montana State. First carry of the day for the leading rusher, and he runs right in to his own man. And a loss of 2, Robert Shaw credited with the tackle. Cody Kirk did not practice all week, resting that left knee. He spent every practice standing behind Denarius McGee and the first team offense getting mental reps, but no physical reps for the junior from Frenchtown, Montana, their leading rusher.
In a difficult night when you're not getting reps and working up a lather as a running back to get in and be productive right away.
Play action off the counter. McGee pressured. Has a man and incomplete off of the hand of Brian Flodketter. Let's go down to Allison Williams for more on Cody Kirk.
Well, just watching him on the sideline, guys, he's constantly jumping up and down, sprinting up and down the sidelines. I think just trying to keep warm, keep involved. I don't know how much they will use him, how effective he will be, but it seems they're really just trying to be cautious with him. They know he's not 100%, but as this game goes on, you know he will be there for his team. Coaches talked about what a fighter he is, how tough he is, and he'll be out there as much as they'll let him be.
Allison, thanks. He had 10 touches last week against Stony Brook before injuring that knee. 8 carries and a couple of catches. Bullet near side, right at the 30 and caught by John Ellis. And they'll be just short, a yard short of the first down.
Great concentration by John Ellis, but it may be 1 yard too short to bring out the punt team. Chris throw from the pocket, good clean protection for McGee. He's definitely in bounds, but shy of the 30-yard line. Needed to get to the 31 for a first down.
And so Rory Perez to kick it away. This matchup last year in the semis changed on special teams, and an 82-yard kickoff return for a touchdown. Trey Diller back to receive this punt. They come after it, nearly got it, and the punter goes down, no flag. Diller to the 30. Forced out at nearly the 32. Well, that was a tough exchange for Perez. He also got a little bit of extra love after the whistle by one of the Sam Houston State special teamers, JT Cleveland. We'll show you all of that when we come back to Bozeman. Slippery turf, and his own man may have taken him down. 10-3 Bearcats. Beautiful country everywhere you look at here. Highlight Reservoir, Highlight Reserve, just due south of Bozeman. Big sky country. And greeted with snowfall yesterday and more to come tonight.
You know, Tom, if I'm Sam Houston State, it might be out of character for them But I might come and fake a little bit of play action and try to hit a big play down the field here on first down.
Randall, the quarterback, will hand it off to Flanders. Flanders trying to find the edge, and he gets tripped up by Darius Jones. Pickup of six at time for the junior from Midwest City, Oklahoma, who redshirted at Kansas State his first year. And then transferred in to Sam Houston State. Immediate impact, 2010 Southland Conference Freshman of the Year.
Yeah, 22 school records, and eight times he's gone over 100 yards this season alone.
Keyshawn Hill replaces him in the backfield. Bell to throw on the run. Pretty ball. Sincere, the intended receiver, incomplete. Jones with the coverage. Well, it's obvious they're trying to get the ball to their playmakers.
Absolutely. Get the ball in space to your playmakers. That time, Sincere was trying to run a corner route. A lot of contact on the outside with Darius Jones. No flag called, but it looked like Brian Bell wanted to throw the football down the field, stretch the field for the Sam Houston State offense.
Only one third down conversion tonight. That belongs to Sam Houston State.
And this might be more of a quarterback run for them on third down.
Bell will keep it. And he scrambles his way for a Bearcat first down. Caleb Schreibeis with the stop.
What I like about Bell so far in this game is that he understands down and distance. When you need five, he's going to get six. And he makes good decision in the run game. He sticks the football in there, and then he gets north and south because he knew he just needed a long five to move the chains and keep his offense on the football field.
Brian's brother, Sean, was a quarterback at Baylor. And then after graduation, was his offensive coordinator at China Springs High School for his dad, Mark. It was truly a family affair. He said, if you ask my mom what a cover two is, she can break it down. Bell to throw, deep ball. Wide open, Trey Diller. Touchdown, Bearcats.
You can't get any more open than Trey Diller did on that post route. Just an excellent throw, wide open. He's going to be at the bottom of the screen. He's going to feint outside, and that turns Darius Jones to the sideline, and it opens up the middle of the field. That's one of the easier throws you're ever gonna get for Brian Bell. He puts it right on the money to Diller for a 56-yard touchdown.
Antonio punches it through. Sam Houston State has scored 14 straight. Last year, they turned it around with a kickoff return and 29 unanswered. 14 straight here on a great move by Diller. 17-3, Bearcats.
There are stars and there are superstars. And then there was Bo Jackson.
I danced to the beat of my drums, not nobody else's.
He was a phenomenon, but that phenomenon was so brief.
What if I told you he could do anything and did? ESPN Films presents a 30 for 30 film brought to you by Buick Verano. You don't know Bo. Saturday at 9 on ESPN.
I am proud to say that I've gotten my DirecTV bill down to just $12 a month. And all I did was refer people I already knew.
His eyes are going to be in the offensive backfield, and that's going to allow on the outside Diller to make that cut to the outside. Look at the eyes are to the sideline where they should be to the middle of the field. And that's because play action held Bethley first. And the great move to the outside by Diller right here. He spins the cornerback, Darius Jones, and there's nobody in the middle of the field. All you have to do is play pitch and catch. And I'm sure for Brian Bell, there was no arguments at the dinner table if his dad was taught watching that one or his brother. That's the way you want to do it.
Four plays, 68 yards. Last two drives, 12 plays, 147 yards and two touchdowns. In dominating drives for the Bearcats offense. Brian Bell had a chance to go play at Baylor this season. Two of their three losses came to the big schools, Baylor and Texas A&M, to close the regular season. Sean Johnson, Everett Gilbert back. Johnson from the one. 14-yard return. Kenneth Jenkins with the special team stop for Sam Houston State. ESPN's critically acclaimed film series 30 for 30 returns Saturday with a bio on two sports star Bo Jackson, examining the truths, myths, and legend of an extraordinary athlete who transformed into a cultural icon. You don't know Bo, Saturday at 9 on ESPN, presented by Buick Verano. His running backs coach Jack Crow just finished up his FCS career at Jacksonville State, told me a great story. He said, Bo was playing an all-star game in the Superdome. He saw the punters trying to hit the speakers in the Superdome. Asked what they were doing. They told him, he said, let me try. First kick, boom, hits a speaker hanging from the roof of the Superdome. McGee, pressure from behind, and he goes down at the 5. A 10-yard sack for Andrew Weaver, the Texas A&M transfer.
Plenty of time that time for McGee to try to find a receiver, but it was good coverage down the field. And you're going to see Weaver on the outside. He's just going to come, and he's relentless with his pressure. He's going to get upfield. First, he's going to slow play on the outside. Then he gets around Stephen Foster and is able to sack Denarius McGee deep in the backfield. Second and long for Montana State.
Second and 20 from the end zone. McGee pressured again. Gets some help and slips as he lets a deep one go incomplete. Bleskin was coming back, and McGee let it go deep. Was that just a result of the pressure?
I think so. I think he was just trying to get that football close and just trying to get rid of it. Didn't want to take a sack because a sack there would have meant points, a safety. So he just tried to get rid of the football. But on third and or second and 20, very difficult. You just want to pick some yardage back so you get a manageable third down.
The Sam Houston State defense shut down Cal Poly's triple option offense, third best rushing offense in the nation last week. Third and 20. Design quarterback draw. McGee runs by the official but can't get by the Bearcats. Jesse Beauchamp had 17 tackles against Cal Poly, including 13 solo tackles, brings him down.
Yeah, no one even knew Jesse's name last year because he was one of those backup guys, but he played so well early this season, replaced someone that was injured, and then he made a name for himself. As you said, had a huge game last week and a nice season coming into the game with 83 total tackles.
Beauchamp only had 31 tackles in his career coming into the season and had more than half that total in one game last week.
Sometimes you just need an opportunity, right?
Second straight three and out for Montana State. Diller fair catch. And the Bearcats have a chance to add to their lead. The offense is certainly on time now, thanks in large part to great field position. And the defense, with this monster sack of McGee, set him up for success again.
Here's another one.
There we go.
All over the world, families are building a moment together, one Lego brick at a time.
Available at Macy's, your fragrance destination.
17-3, Sam Houston State leads. Three seed Montana State as the Bearcats look for an upset on the road against a Montana State defense, which last week against Stony Brook was fantastic. They held Stony Brook to 150 yards below their season rush average. And look at the numbers so far tonight versus what they've accomplished over the course of the season.
And tonight it's been a different story because you have a quarterback in Brian Bell that can not only run the football, but he can throw the football very efficiently through the air, over 100 yards, 126 on only 4 completions. So they're big plays in the passing game. And then it seems like Timothy Flanders is getting on track. He had a long of 27 in that last touchdown drive.
Top 8 defense in the nation coming into this one. And held Stony Brook to 10 points, held Montana to just 7 points in their rivalry game. Richard Sincere is back in a wild Bearcat. The speedster is usually a wide receiver. Flanders hit at the line of scrimmage, and the defense looking for a stop. No gain. Nah, Moyakiola with the stop, the junior from Euless Trinity.
Tom, they need to get some excitement on this football field. Get the crowd back in the game. Try to get a turnover, try to tackle the football and gain some momentum with field position. But that's a nice tackle by a strong linebacker. So you have to get, you have to tackle the football, try to create a turnover if you're Montana State right now.
Sincere still in at quarterback. Bell is warming his hands on the Sam Houston State sideline. Quarterback run, little option. Sincere hit at midfield, and he's still able to squirm his way for a few. Joel Fuller, the senior from Libby, Montana, with the stop. All-conference safety, but ends up as a gain of 5.
Important third down for Montana State defensively. They have to find a way to get off the field and go 3 and out in this set of downs.
Bearcats 2 of 4 on third down tonight. Converted each of their last 2.
Remember, this was quarterback run the last set of downs they were in this situation.
Flag on the play. They jump. This will be a free play and a first down for Sam Houston State. And they'll just throw it out of bounds.
Best pass incomplete.
Offsides, defense, number 49, 5-yard penalty, results in a first down.
Well, you know why Caleb Schreibeis is active and he's anxious to make a play. He's been in on a sack every game this season. But Montana State's defense does not have a signature play tonight, and they've been scored on in each of the last 2 drives.
And they need to find a signature play here on this set of downs defensively.
Third straight, third down conversion for Sam Houston State. Bell uses a timeout.
Timeout. Sam Houston State, first timeout. It will be a 30-second timeout.
It's going to be tough to get to Bell. He's only been sacked 4 times all year, and 3 of those came courtesy of the Baylor Bears.
He's a smart quarterback. He knows where he wants to go with the football. And he has playmakers around him, Tom, that allow him open windows to throw it.
The 2012 NCAA Division I Football Championship continues next weekend with semifinals on December 14th and 15th. Both games will be on the ESPN networks. For more information, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 89 NCAA championships. Bracket will expand next season to 24 teams, which means another AQ and 3 more qualifiers can get in. Here's a look at what the way the bracket looks now, headed towards the semifinals with 3 games tomorrow. Only 2 unseeded teams left, Wofford, Sam Houston State, and Illinois State. I know Towson and Richmond would have loved that extra at-large berth this season. On the outside looking in out of the CAA. Hit in the backfield, Flanders. Stopped by Na'a Moyakiola again. Moyakiola, part of that pipeline down to Texas and specifically to powerhouse Euless Trinity High School.
Well, he has speed, and he has speed from the inside, so it's nice to watch him react to the football. He's going to go downhill and react to the run on first down, so he's instinctive. He gets by the block of White, the big left guard, and he gets excited and gets his crowds back into this football game. They have to find an impactful play defensively here.
Second and 12. Ryan Bell lets it go. Back foot. Incomplete. Chance Nelson was his intended receiver. Third and 12 now for Sam Houston State. Well, he said the Bobcats needed a stop. And the offsides call cost him on the last third down.
It really did. Now the crowd's going to get back into it. It's going to be a third and 12. So Brian Bell offensively needs to make a good decision, get everybody under control, because it's going to get loud here in a second.
will bring four. Down the sideline, Diller, incomplete. James Andrews had the coverage near side on the big wide receiver from Spring, Texas.
And that's the three and out they needed. After the penalty, moved the chains for Sam Houston State. Montana State responded. They got a nice tackle on first down in the middle of the field, good pressure on second down, and good coverage on third down. But that offense is going to stay out on the field here with fourth and long.
They're going to go for it on fourth and 12.
Might be a quick kick.
And it's a bad snap. Bell has to chase it down. He's going to throw it. Caught at the 35, short of the first down. But what a save when it comes to field position. Brandon Wilkerson scrambled to haul it in.
An amazing play by Brian Bell just to get on the football and then have the presence of mind to locate the defense. This snap is well to the right of him, but he takes a peek before he gets the football. Then he regains his composure, finds a receiver down the field, and almost picks up the first down.
It turns into a gain of 8 on third and 12. It's a difference in field position of 30 yards, roughly.
And that was the big play Montana State needed. They still get the football with great field position.
Here comes the blitz from the Bearcats. Hand off to Orenzo Davis. And he fights his way for perhaps two straight up the middle. What can Montana State do against the pressure from the Bearcats?
They have to start maybe moving the pocket on first down, Tom, because they look like they've lost their rhythm running the football without Cody Kirk. There's no timing in the run on first down, so they have to move the pocket and use Denarius in a run pass option on first down.
Corner blitz coming now on McGee. He's got a scramble and he fires incomplete. Not only have they out their number one running back, Cody Kirk, who's a power back, but they're asking Orenzo Davis, more of a perimeter guy, to run up the middle.
And Tom, I say that because you're going to get consistent pressure from Sam Houston State defensively. You're going to get a lot of man coverage. So on first down, if you give the illusion of running the football in a basic set and then test the defensive backs down the field, you only have to hit one big play to make this a one-score game.
Third and 8 now. Bobcats have gone 3 and out each of their last two possessions. 6 total yards to show for it. Complete well shy of the first down to Everett Gilbert. Kenneth Jenkins, who has a pick today, with the stop for the Bobcats. And the offense, for the third straight possession, will leave the field after 3 plays.
Disappointing for the Bobcats, but there again on defense, you see the speed of the Bearcats. They're able to react and tackle in space and keep the Bobcats offense on the sidelines after 3 and out.
Only 13 yards to show for each of their last 3 possessions. And Montana State 0 for 6 on third down tonight.
Last time they came close did Sam Houston State to blocking the punt.
Perez gets that one off clean. Diller another fair catch. And he'll stand at the 25-yard line. 33-yard punt. One other thing we're seeing, Montana State going 3 and out, 3 straight possessions, is their defense has been on the field a lot here in the second quarter.
They really have, and it's a credit to Brian Bell and Timothy Flanders and the playmakers they have on offense, because they're able to take a look at the clock now with 4:31. This could be a defining moment for them. If they can take 3.5 minutes off of the clock and get some points going into halftime, they're going to ride the crest of emotion in the strong play of this first half.
Bearcats have doubled up on the Bobcats' time of possession here in the second quarter. More than 6 minutes to less than 3. Out route complete. And dancing out of bounds is Brandon Williams, freshman from LaGrange, Texas. Back-to-back catches for Wilkerson, who's coming on.
Nice protection, quick passing game. I know head coach Willie Fritz likes what he sees in his quarterback because he's making nice decisions. He's been accurate with the football. He's protected it well. And he's just running the offense within the system that makes you successful throughout the entire year. He's protecting the football nicely tonight.
Sam Houston State has outgained Montana State by 133 yards in the second quarter. Long pass, complete. Nope, incomplete. Dropped down the perimeter on a long throw to Trey Diller.
Now, Tom, that was a tight window to throw that football. Just a slight half roll to the middle of the field. Well covered underneath by Flowers. That had to be a perfect throw. See Bell's numbers fairly accurate, around 50% tonight.
Home crowd looking for something to cheer about. Richard Sincere back in at quarterback now. Play clock at 5. Fumbled the snap. Still has the option open, and Sincere wrestled to the ground at the 46-yard line.
Little
Johnny Manziel like on that play.
They're getting a lot of good bounces in this first half, because if one goes a different way, it looked like a guy in a blue jersey would be on the football. Great patience by Richard Sincere just to calmly continue with the play with the ball being on the ground, and Tom making a positive play out of something that it could have been disastrous.
Last year in the semifinal matchup, Montana State missed on assignments out of the option, gave up two big quarterback runs of 50-plus yards for touchdowns. Diller caught it. First down, Sam Houston State. Another big one for Diller. Jones with the coverage.
He may have stepped out of bounds and come back in to catch this football.
Official dropped his hat at the 35-yard line. Patriot League crew here
Receiver
tonight.
Receiver was forced out of bounds. Legally came back in the field, caught the ball, complete.
You like the way Trey Diller goes up and attacks the football. He high points the football very nicely. He's got a 40-inch vertical. He didn't have to use all of it, but he was able to turn his head around, locate the football before the defensive back could react.
He's over 100 yards. It's his third catch of 20 yards or better tonight, including a 56-yard touchdown. Flanders. A loss of a couple. Jody Owens in to make the play. Sixth tackle of the night for the senior from Mesquite Horn High School in Texas.
Plenty of time left for the Bearcats here. Two timeouts remaining. They can take their time, get organized offensively, try to get a positive play here on second down.
Flanders, room, hurdles for a first down. He jumped right over the top of 6 foot Joel Fuller.
We talked about the athleticism of this team. No better example than on the sidelines. You mentioned it. Joe Fuller goes low from the safety spot, no problem. Timothy Flanders elevates, and his head coach Willie Fritz loves it.
Willie Fritz and Timothy Flanders came to Huntsville at the same time. About a 1-2 combination. Only loss last season for Sam Houston State came in the national championship game. Flanders hit. Still manages a couple. Caleb Schreibeis with the stop for Montana State. Flanders came in averaging 104 yards a game and 17 touchdowns in the season. Averaging better than 4 yards a carry tonight.
And his average on the year over 6. So they've been able to somewhat contain him, but he had that long for 27, and he's dangerous in the red zone because he can break an arm tackle and score points.
Quarterback's going to keep it. Lost the football right outside the pylon. Brian Bell recovered it after getting another friendly hop off the turf. That's the third time Sam Houston State has put the ball on the ground, and it's come right back up to a Bearcat.
You called it correctly, Tom. That is the third time they get the great bounce. Love the way Brian Bell extends the play. He stretches that option play out and puts the defense in a no-win situation. Watch him extend the play, and he extends Joe Fuller out where he can't make a decision. Good, tough tackle on the outside by Cole Moore. He strips the football, but nobody in a blue jersey could get back on it. Great awareness by Bell.
So it sets up a first and goal for Sam Houston State.
He just scored 14 unanswered after this game is tied at 3. Flanders. Stood up by Fuller and others.
But this is exactly what Sam Houston State wanted to do with this drive. They got the football around the 4-minute mark, and they're going to be able to get points, hopefully, out of this drive and leave, really, Montana State with no time on the clock.
Two timeouts remaining for the Bearcats if they feel like they need to talk it over. Second and goal. They only trailed once at half the season. That was to Texas A&M. Flanders will take the direct snap. Straight ahead. And he stopped just short. And that will set up a third and goal.
They need to call a timeout.
Game clock will be stopped with a Bearcat timeout. One of the wrinkles we're seeing from Sam Houston State this game is when they go to the Wildcat.
Timeout. Sam Houston State, second timeout.
Whether it's Flanders or Sincere, they're keeping Bell on the field and motioning him out to a wideout.
Yeah, they're getting him outside, so maybe a new wrinkle in this offense to give them the option of a double pass or getting him back in the offense.
Please reset the game clock to 8 seconds.
8 seconds remain. They still have a timeout. You're looking at third and goal, and you have a power back in Flanders. Can you run the ball?
Absolutely. That's what you do here on third and goal. You run the football with your best athlete.
Well, the Bearcats have had a very good game offensively. And great balance between run and pass.
They've had some big plays on the outside. There, Timothy Flanders goes for 27 here. Sincere goes for 12 and a score, but it's been the quarterback as well. He's been able to run the football and move the chains when they needed to. And when they needed him to step up and be accurate with the football, he's able to find Trey Diller wide open down the middle of the football field for a 56-yard touchdown.
So third and goal here. Bell comes back out along with Flanders.
And they've had some problems with that shotgun snap. See if the quarterback goes under center.
He will with Flanders behind him. He's going to throw. Batted away. Incomplete. But the clock stops with 5 seconds left, fourth and goal.
Wow, I'm not so sure I would have put the football in Timothy Flanders' hands. If you can't get a half a yard or your quarterback, that's something that's a test for your offensive line. You have to win at the point of attack. And it looks like they're going to keep 4 points on the football field if they convert here.
Antonio on to attempt an 18-yarder. Well, Sam Houston State has scored 17 unanswered, but what a break for Montana State to come up with that goal line stop and hold the Bearcats to just a field goal.
Really no throwing lane. The wide receiver is going to come right down the goal line and Trey Diller, but it looked like on the outside, 44, Grozelak, the linebacker, gets his hand on the football.
Let's take you down to the field now, and Allison Williams.
Thanks, guys. Coach Ash, a big goal line stand there, but this triple option causes so many problems. What's been the most difficult for you to defend?
You know, it's just the speed still of the game. I think we're in good shape a lot of times, and then they'll just outrun our option player that's assigned to the guy that has the ball. So we just have to keep playing fast, and I think we'll be okay. This was huge. Give us something to go into the halftime now, something positive to build on.
How do you get the offense going in the second half?
We've got to get it going. We've got to start throwing the ball. They're pressuring on every down, and we got to make them pay with the man-to-man coverage that we're seeing. Get something going with the pass game. That'll open up the run.
Thank you.
They expected the pressure, but McGee's only thrown for 61 yards in the first half. CAA FCS Football Championship presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Welcome back to Bozeman, Montana. Dominating second quarter for Sam Houston State, and they lead 20-3 at the half. Moments ago, Allison Williams caught up with Willie Fritz.
Coach Fritz, offensively, how were you able to be so dominant in the first half, and in particular that second quarter?
Well, we're doing a good job of running the football. It's opening up a lot of play action pass for us downfield.
With the lead you have at the half, up by 17, what's the message to your guys?
We just got to keep playing. We've got 30 minutes, and we just got to stay after and keep doing what we're doing. Made some good adjustments at halftime, but we're going to come out and play hard this second half.
Thanks, Coach Fritz.
Thank you.
Take a look at the second quarter numbers. Outgaining Montana State 205-13. They had the ball for 12 of 15 minutes and scored 17 points.
When you can stay on the field that long and be that productive and really throw a goose egg at Montana State, you know that you're playing on all cylinders offensively. So 17 points in that second quarter, and you get the ball back to start the second half.
Sam Houston State looking for an upset on the road. And his kickoff out of the back of the end zone at elevation here, 5,900 feet. Time now to spin it forward.
Well, Sam Houston State, they were able to spread the wealth around to their playmakers. Timothy Flanders was one of those guys. He had 65 yards in the first half, had a big run there. And then the smaller back, Richard Sincere, he's been able to be productive, gets in the end zone. But all of that running was able to set up the pass down the field, the vertical game where Brian Bell was able to hit Trey Diller down the field for that 56-yard touchdown. So if Sam Houston State offensively can continue to get their playmakers involved, not just one guy, but two or three guys, spread that wealth around, continue to keep Montana State on their heels.
Ryan Bell at quarterback. Here's Flanders. And picks up a yard. Caleb Schreibeis in on the tackle for Montana State. Flanders, 19 carries today. He only had 17 against Cal Poly and still crossed the 100-yard mark.
Yeah, he had a big week last week, as you mentioned, against Cal Poly, but that was the eighth time he went over 100 yards, and I believe if they feed him a little bit in this third and fourth quarter, he'll be able to continue that streak, take it to 9 games this year.
Quarterback rotation continues. Richard Sincere back in the Wild Bearcat, and the option to the short side, and he's thrown for a loss. Alex Singleton comes up with a big play for Montana State, a loss of 2.
On the first two plays defensively for Montana State, this team's really coming out and playing hard. Watch him get to the backfield. He's going to scrape down the line with the option, but he's going to get in behind those blocks. Nobody's assigned to 43. Alex Singleton, big play on second down. Tackle for loss puts him in a nice spot on third down.
Third and 11. Bell is converted with his legs and with his arm, and third and long so far tonight, both in the second quarter. He keeps it and makes his way to the 30.
And he's hurt on the sidelines.
James Andrews had the stop, and Bell is still now to his feet, and he's limping off.
I think he was holding that right side, his right leg. We can see how Brian Bell on the sidelines trying to turn it up. He got that knee, it looked like, bent underneath him. His right leg gets bent underneath him, slides out on that turf. Let's hope he's okay to come out, because he's been really dealing the running game and throwing the football down the field very efficiently.
Fourth and 5, setting up for a return. And David Dash took the fair catch at the 25. 45-yard punt for Matt Foster. Bell, little banged up. Sincere has been fantastic as they rotate quarterbacks, but he's certainly not a thrower.
It seemed like that right leg just slid out, and he immediately held the back, almost his hamstring, like his hamstring on the right side looked like it may have been tweaked, but that right leg just slid out of bounds. It's a cold night, and that turf, very slick.
Wind chill has a temperature, feels like in the teens. 70 degrees today back home in Huntsville, Texas for this Sam Houston State team. A long pass complete, and John Ellis squirts free to pick up 7. You know, one of the things the coaches told us is they didn't want McGee to drop back and throw to the wide side of the field, yet they're doing it.
And they've had success doing it. I think McGee needs to do more of it. I think they're going to get away from the running game. And Rob Ash told Allison at halftime, they're going to start throwing the football a little bit more. I expect them to do that here in this drive.
Second and 2. Had a man open who wasn't looking, and McGee goes down at the 30. Flodketter was open, and he wasn't even looking back at the quarterback. And must be miscommunication.
Yeah, Tom, I'm not so sure Denarius thought he was going to run another route. He didn't expect him to come in on that slant. Maybe didn't locate him with his eyes, didn't trust it because he wasn't expecting his big wideout to be there.
Montana State 0 for 6 on third down conversions tonight. Incomplete.
No flag. Ellis, the intended receiver, Robert Shaw, was in his pocket. He was on him like that hand warmer around his waist.
Absolutely. This defense is tenacious, and they're quick, and they react to the football. That's just a good play on the football by Robert Shaw. He gets down, almost picks this football off. He beat the wide receiver to the spot. Anytime you do that as a defender, you're going to win.
This will be another three and out. And McGee talking with Flotketter on the sideline. They're certainly not on the same page on that play. They're going to fake the punt. Got it! Rory Perez took off. And there's the change that Montana State was looking for. Some sort of momentum.
The crowd likes it, and I'm sure the offense likes it coming back on the field. You saw them discussing the last set of downs on the outside. This is a great gutsy call by Rob Ash, and he's able to get Roy Perez just about a yard more than he needed. That should ignite this offense. I won't be surprised they try to go deep here on first down.
On the jet sweep, they hand it off. Room to run for Gilbert. And Gilbert scrambles his way to the 49. Back-to-back first downs for Montana State. Forced out by Dak Swanson. In the first half, Montana State only had one drive of four plays or longer. That was their 10-play field goal drive.
Well, you get the fake punt, you get Gilbert on the end around. Now you have some momentum to build on if you're Darius McGee.
Down the sideline, incomplete. Trying to find Tanner Bleskin. To go back to something. Tom Harden, former pick quarterback John Kingemi. After you've got into it with your wide receiver and there is miscommunication and we don't know who's at fault, is it tough then to go back to that guy in the next
not
series
at all.
Or later in the game?
No, Tom, not at all. You got to get it out of your system. You got to let your receiver know what you expect out of him and then go right back to him. Because you've made it this far, you're playing for a championship. You can't let those little things get in the way of where you're trying to be as a team.
Johnson scrambles his way forward to the 46-yard line. Flotketter is on the sideline for now, and now a host of subs return for Montana State, including Brian Flotketter.
Well, the big loss for Montana State tonight has been the loss of their starting running back, Cody Kirk. He tried to give it a go about the third or fourth series, wasn't able to get it done, and now all the pressure resides at the quarterback position, either running the football or getting it out of his hand in the passing game.
Denarius McGee to throw against pressure. Caught on the slant, Tanner Bleskin, and a Montana State first down. That's their first third down conversion tonight after starting 0-for-7.
Tough catch by the 6'3 receiver. Right side of the screen. Good throw, good timing, and a tough catch over the middle against zero coverage. Nobody in the middle. Sam Houston State brings pressure, and they're going to do that the entire second half. But Bleskin up to the challenge.
Bobcats turning it up with no huddle, trying to pick up the tempo. And there's a grab at the 20-yard line. Bleskin again.
Nice awareness by McGee, the quarterback, to slow his wide receiver down in Bleskin. He was covered on the outside, but he throws it behind. Watch this. The ball's going to come out. It's going to be a fade route. But all he's going to do is stop him with the throw. Watch him stop him back shoulder. He throws away from the defense. And if you're a defender and you don't turn your head, you're going to get beat every time.
A break for Bleskin. Gilbert in motion. He wants to throw. McGee was wrapped up, had nowhere to go. He'll get flagged for holding, and the pass is incomplete. They wanted to throw back to their quarterback, Denarius McGee, and the Sam Houston State defensive lineman just put him in a bear hug, and that'll be a penalty against the Bearcats.
But Tom, you can feel the momentum in this game changing. Coming out of the locker room, this is a different offense for Montana State.
Holding, defense, number 91. Penalty will be half the distance from the previous spot. Still first down.
Preston Sanders.
There's the pitch by Denarius. He's going to try to get outside,
but he's held by Preston Sanders. A hog collar on the outside, and that's going to cost you yardage. And now Montana State knocking at the door in the red zone inside the 10-yard line.
They had 13 yards in the second quarter total. 65 yards on this drive now for the Bobcats at Montana State.
And watch for quarterback run inside this red zone.
Denarius McGee will keep it, follows his blocker, and gets popped a step past the line of scrimmage by Darius Taylor.
And Tom Taylor was the linebacker that was out last week with an ankle injury. Looks like he's 100% because this is a good tackle by a middle linebacker. Watch him step up and just square up and hit the quarterback.
Jesse Beauchamp had him down low. Darius Taylor cleaned him up. And facing a second and goal, his Patriot League officiating staff stops it for a moment. White hat having a discussion. Yes, Montana State's offense has turned it up, but their defense started it for them in the second half by forcing three and out. I didn't see a flag.
No, and when you have momentum on offense, you want to get that rhythm up and running.
The penalty was not an automatic first down. Therefore, it should have been second or first down, half a yard. That play gained the half yard. We now have first and goal for Montana. He okay?
I've never seen that.
No, and Willie Fritz wanted an explanation on the sideline as well. He's got a laughing it off, but wants his defense now to respond.
Went back to correct themselves after Montana State had run a play. So first and goal from inside the nine. Ellis in motion. Denarius McGee keeps it. Five. Touchdown, Montana State.
So the offense responds after a defensive three and out, and it's all Denarius McGee, the running of the quarterback. He gets in for 8 yards, and now Montana State back in this football game.
What in the world did Rob Ash say in the locker room?
Whatever it was, he better bottle it, because this team is a different team in this third quarter.
Extra point is no good. Hooked by the lefty Perez. Thanks in large part to pressure. But perhaps it's that pressure and getting after kicks which allowed Montana State the courage to call for the fake punt on fourth and four. They ran for five, kept the drive alive. An 11-play drive turns into Montana State's first touchdown of the game. 20-9, nearly midway through the third.
Trophy presentation tomorrow at 8 on ESPN.
You asked me to find the 14th member of this company, and I have chosen Mr. Beckins.
Me? No.
Montana State is back in this game after a miserable second quarter. 20-9 is the Sam Houston State lead here in Bozeman. The drive turned around on a fourth and four after a frustrating miscommunication between quarterback and wide receiver, and Rory Perez, a junior from Moreno Valley, California, carried it to refresh the downs, and Denarius McGee with his fifth rushing touchdown of the season.
And it brought the offense back on the football field, and you can see from the first half to what they did to start this third quarter, 11 plays, 75 yards, they get points, and they needed it desperately. They needed to find an identity on offense, and I think it's going to be from here on out the running mixed in with a little attack on first down, throwing the football from McGee at the quarterback position.
A rowdy atmosphere here in Bozeman at Bobcat Stadium. They're hosting back-to-back postseason games for the first time since 1984.
the championship season here in Bozeman. A.J. Silva will kick it off. 50% of his kicks at home are touchbacks. Comes up short on this one to the four, Keyshawn Hill. Hill gets a block. Spins out to the 23-yard line. Let's take you back to the studio now for an update with Chris Cotter.
Hey, Tom, Sixers and Celtics, final seconds of overtime, and this game was over on ESPN earlier tonight. Evan Turner, who had 26 in this game, buries the jumper to give Philadelphia the leads. Celtics had one last shot. Ron.
Chris, thank you. Brian Bell back at quarterback for Sam Houston State, and quickly works one to the outside to Chance Nelson. And Deontay Flowers with the stop. Let's check in with Allison Williams.
Well, guys, we saw Brian Bell come off the field limping. He never was tended to by any trainers. He definitely was in pain, though. You could see him cringing. He did go and get on the bike trying to work through whatever was ailing him. But as you can see, guys, back out there without missing a snap.
And he heads off the field now, which is not odd because Richardson Sear, out of that wild Bearcat, is back to take the snap and checks at the sideline. Sincere's throwing a couple of touchdowns out of the wild Bearcat, but he's also thrown an interception this season. Limited passing attempts. Flanders. Bulls over a guy, and that'll set up third and short for Sam Houston State. And not only the Montana State back into it, but also the home crowd here at Bobcat Stadium. Well, the home team has won 18 of its last 21 playing here. 5,900 feet of elevation up in the Rockies. Third and a long one. Play clock at three. Flanders straight ahead, first down, and the power game for the Bearcats. Keeps this drive alive. Brad Daly with the stop.
Tom, sometimes you have to trust your offensive line. When it's third and one, third and two, you have to go downhill. And I think that's what Willie Fritz did on that play. Trusted those big guys up front. You don't have this much success in the triple option unless you can put a hat on a hat and move people against their will. And that's what Sam Houston did, State did on that play, third and short.
Full house backfield. He wants to throw. Over the middle, incomplete. Good coverage downfield for Montana State team that has gotten bitten by play action already tonight.
Well, that time Darius Jones didn't turn his back. Played the football in the quarterback. He was able to look inside and play the receiver. He got a little grab on that left side, but it helped him catch up to Trey Diller. Wasn't caught by the official. But Jones's eyes, they were inside. That's where you need to be. Get that player and the quarterback in your vision and then play the football.
Second and 10. Bell will scramble. Design draw. He's got a first down straight up the middle. Joel Fuller with the stop.
Brian Bell's so good at understanding down and distance and what he needs to get. He's aware on the football field, knows where the chains are, and then get down. He suffered that big hit on the sidelines. You want to keep number 11 in the football game because he can impact you by running the football like he did there, but also stretching it vertically.
Deep ball again, wide open and through the hands of Keyshawn Hill. Both teams have had a running back have a touchdown go through their hands.
And that's just a free release by the back. He's going to run right past Joel Fuller. And this is wide open. You have to be able to convert. Perfect play by Brian Bell. Lays up with enough air to make it an easy catch. And Keyshawn would love to have that one back.
Hill only has two catches on the season. Play clock will get to single digits again. J. Toss to Flanders. Singleton with the stop. And he'll lose a couple. Alex Singleton, the sophomore from Thousand Oaks, California, is having a whale of a game as Jody Owens' backup.
We talked about Owens being instinctive. That was an excellent play on the first step by Alex Singleton. No hesitation. He went downhill and met the running back in the backfield for a big loss on second down.
Third and long, over the middle, caught and hit, and forward progress will have a Bearcat first down at the 41 to Chance Nelson. Ryan Bell stands tall in the pocket again.
He really does, Tom. This is a nice job of scanning the field. He's going to look to the field side first, but the timing, that window was there. The ball comes out right on time, and I don't care what defense you run, if the ball comes out on time, and it's accurate where you want to put it, there's not a defense that can defend the perfect pass. And that time, the timing beat the defense.
And now this Montana State defense having to do it without their best player. Jody Owens is out on the sideline. Richard Sincere back in at quarterback. Flanders. And Sincere kept it. Montana State thought they ripped it away. So Montana State is down. It's starting running back. And its leading tackler in the Big Sky, defensive MVP Jody Owens, who's bundled up on the Bobcat sideline.
Second down.
Two guys that affect the football team, one on offense and one on defense. There's Jody Owens on the defensive side. We've already talked about the loss of Cody Kirk, the running back, on the offensive side.
Owens' helmet is nowhere near. Second and 13. Flanders. Joe Fuller forces him out. It's an 11-point game after Montana State missed the extra point, and Sam Houston State is controlling the clock.
The one good thing that Sam Houston State does offensively, if they don't win on first down, they sure do come back with a positive play to keep third down manageable. And that's why I think Brian Bell's been so successful tonight. He's been able to move the chains when they need to. And now is one of those times.
Flanders needs four. He won't get one. Thrown for a loss by Brian Bignell. Fourth down coming. Remember, Sam Houston State went for it on fourth down. In a similar situation in the second quarter, they got seven to go here. And they'll bring on the punter, Matt Foster.
And with Jody Owens out of the game, Singleton's come out with big plays, but this time it was Bignell, the big number 99 at the point of attack, that makes the play in the Sam Houston State backfield.
Matt Foster is a Purdue transfer at punter, senior from Australia. Trying to kill this one inside the 10. Fantastic special teams play by Sam Houston State. Vincent Dotson ran underneath it and grabs it inside the 5. A 35-yard punt to back up Montana State. But the Bobcats defense coming up with big plays even without their star player.
Well, it's that time of year again. Time to get a holiday deal on a Ram truck. A truck that will pretty much haul anything. With a legendary Hemi engine and proven durability that goes the distance. And while most families bring their tree to the house, Ram families bring their house to the tree. Get a great deal at the Ram Big Finish event.
Right now, get 0% APR financing for 60 months on select 2012 Ram 1500 models.
DNA augmentation initiated.
neural speeds increasing to 4G LTE. Brain upgrading to a quad-core processor. Predictive intelligence with Google Now complete.
Introducing Droid DNA by HTC. It's not an upgrade to your phone. It's an upgrade to yourself.
I have a cold. I took DayQuil, but I still have a runny nose.
DayQuil doesn't treat that.
Huh?
Alka-Seltzer Plus rushes relief to all your worst cold symptoms, plus it relieves your runny nose.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
That's the cold truth.
The NCAA FCS Football Championship is brought to you by Ram Trucks, Guts, Glory, Ram. And Reese's Peanut Butter Cups, the perfect combination of chocolate and peanut butter. Great photos from Yellowstone National Park. Not far from here in Wyoming. Up in Big Sky Country, Bozeman, Montana. Snow came in last night. We still expect some to land before this game is over and overnight. 20-9, Sam Houston State leads Montana State. Let's check in with Allison Williams.
Certainly a blow for the Montana State defense. They will be without senior linebacker Jody Owens, a guy that coaches say has become a real team leader. He's a captain of this defense. He is out with a high ankle sprain, will not return. So Alex Singleton, the sophomore, will have to step up in his absence.
Thanks, Allison. Denarius McGee works from the end zone. Slant again, batted away. What a play by Robert Shaw.
Speed, reaction, awareness from this defense. That's what you get from Sam Houston State. Watch the awareness of the defense coming in and playing the lanes, playing the eyes of Denarius McGee. That's just great reaction from Robert Shaw.
Shaw's been all over the place tonight for Sam Houston State. Bearcats have one takeaway, came in the first quarter. Turn that into a field goal. Lorenzo Davis, senior from Littleton, Colorado. One positive for Davis, even though they're without their starting running back, Cody Kirk, is he has the speed to break a big one. Now, we haven't seen that tonight for Montana State.
No, there hasn't been that much daylight in the running game for the traditional running game. That means for Lorenzo or Trey Robinson getting the football in the eye back and being able to move it down the field with Cody Kirk still on the sidelines.
Bobcats 1 of 8 on third down. Here comes the blitz up the middle. McGee to the slant again. First down. Ellis lost the football. Second takeaway of the night for the Bearcats. Andrew Weaver recovers. A deflating play after Montana State had the first down.
And John Ellis had everything he wanted on the outside. He was able to get inside, catch the football from McGee, but let's credit the effort on the outside of punching the football out by Dak Swanson. He gets that right hand in there right here. He exposes the football, does Ellis, and Swanson does the right thing. He plays the football, and Andrew Weaver gets on top of it.
Sometimes you got to get the bounces. Sam Houston has put the ball on the turf 4 times tonight and hasn't turned it over once. Montana State with one fumble and turns it over. Bell will roll, has time, end zone, touchdown! Chance Nelson, and a quick strike for the Bearcats.
That's what makes this Sam Houston State team so dangerous. They're opportunistic. When they get those turnovers, they know how to turn them into points. And Brian Bell right on the money on the outside. A short corner route. He's on the roll, on the move. Looks outside the entire way and then comes back inside to Chance Nelson for 6.
8th touchdown of the season for Nelson. The extra point is good. And Sam Houston State with its 2nd takeaway of the night turns the momentum. It was a Bobcat first down. One play later, it was a Bearcat touchdown. Sam Houston State in control.
To win the Capital One Cup and be the best in men's and women's college sports, you gotta lay it all on the line. Every play, every game, in every sport. Teams are battling it out for NCAA Division I championships, $400,000 in student-athlete scholarships, and the Capital One Cup trophy. More metal for the case. Follow your school and check the standings at CapitalOneCup.com to see who will win the Capital One Cup.
I wish my patients could see what I see. That over time, having high cholesterol and any of these risk factors can put them at increased risk for plaque buildup in their arteries. So it's even more important to lower their cholesterol. And that's why when diet and exercise alone aren't enough, I prescribe Crestor. In a clinical trial versus Lipitor, Crestor got more high-risk patients' bad cholesterol to a goal of under 100.
Crestor is not right for everyone, like people with liver disease or women who are nursing, pregnant, or may become pregnant. Tell your doctor about other medicines you're taking. Call your doctor right away if you have muscle pain or weakness, feel unusually tired, have loss of appetite, upper belly pain, dark urine, or yellowing of skin or eyes. These could be signs of rare but serious side effects.
Is your cholesterol at goal? Talk to your doctor about Crestor.
If you can't afford your medication, AstraZeneca may be able to help.
Back in Bozeman, and a shout out to his mom. Why not? Sam Houston State with a 27-9 lead. Chance Nelson, sophomore from Baytown, Texas, and a Texas A&M transfer, helping the Bearcats increase their lead. It was turned around on a fumble, punched out of the hands of John Ellis, who had enough for the first down.
Opportunistic, because they didn't have to go very far for that drive, and they were able to do it in one play, and they seize all the momentum that Montana State came out of this third quarter, out of the locker room, felt good about the guys in blue coming back. But one turnover and one play later, the Bearcats were able to stretch that lead.
10 points off of turnovers tonight for Sam Houston State. Out of the Southland Conference, Gilbert will take a seat. Let's take a look now at tonight's Reese's perfect play.
And Tom, this is all Brian Bell, the quarterback for Sam Houston State, because he's going to toy a little bit with Deontay Flowers on the outside and the safety. You're going to get a route that's going to split them both to the short corner. Watch the quarterback's eyes in Bell. When he's on the move, he's looking outside to Flowers, keeping him away from the short corner throw back to Chance Nelson. Look at his eyes outside, and then he comes back inside and throws a rope for 6 points.
Son of a coach, his dad Mark, in his 16th year at China Spring High School. His brother Sean, former Baylor quarterback, now a high school coach as well. Robinson. And nothing doing for Montana State, playing without their starting running back. Pardon me, was Cody Kirk. So Kirk back in the game. Montana State has gone no huddle and trying to speed everything up. That led to success first possession in the second half.
And that's what Rob Ash, their head coach, wanted to do, a little bit more up-tempo and try to press the issue, throwing the football more on first down.
29 career touchdowns for Cody Kirk, junior from up in Frenchtown, Montana. Incomplete. Trying to find Flot Ketter. And a flag on the play.
Offsides. Defense, number 43. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Jesse Beauchamp jumps, and now let's check in once again with Chris Cotter.
Tom, tonight we had the NCAA soccer semifinals down in Hoover, Alabama. This is Indiana and Creighton, and that's Femi Hollinger-Jansen right there. With his fourth goal of the year in the 27th minute, Indiana wins. They'll play Georgetown Sunday at 2 o'clock on ESPNU for the title.
All right, thanks, Chris. Pressure on McGee, works it outside, and that's enough for a first down to Tanner Bleskin, junior from Great Falls, Montana. Bleskin's coming off of a huge game against Stony Brook at 130 yards. That tied a Montana State school record for postseason play, and a 69-yard touchdown catch in the first quarter gave the Bobcats a lead they wouldn't surrender.
And Tom, he's going to have to continue to play big as this game gets into the fourth quarter, try to chase points here in the fourth quarter.
Quick hitter to the outside once again. Lee Perkins. Seldom used tight end, only his seventh catch of the season. Head coach Rob Ash saw his team drop a game at Sam Houston State last year in the semifinals. Bearcats' only loss of the season came in the championship game in Frisco. Trying to work their way back to Frisco this season. McGee on the run. Finds the first row. Taylor and Taylor, the twins, brought coverage, brought pressure. 27-9, Sam Houston State leading three-seed Montana State. Our first FCS quarterfinal of the weekend. Montana State, Coach Hamps out of the Big Sky, their third straight conference title. And Sam Houston State went 6-1 in the Southland Conference, three losses on the season. One to Baylor out of the Big 12, one to Johnny Manziel and Texas A&M out of the SEC. And the third came to Central Arkansas when they blew a 10-point lead with 5 minutes to go. McGee pressured. And he was hit as he threw. Darnell Taylor, twin brother of Darius Taylor. They're both out of Mesquite High School. One a safety, one a linebacker. And the Taylors putting their mark on this game last two plays.
And Tom, just too much defensive speed to handle. Nowhere for McGee to throw the football because in the back end, Sam Houston State all over, great man-to-man coverage, and then pressure from the front four and five. When you add pressure by bringing one extra guy, nowhere for McGee to throw the football.
Facing a fourth and seven, false start. Remember, Montana State has already faked one punt tonight.
False start, 16 on the offense, 5 yard penalty. Fourth down.
Cole Moore was the man who jumped. Trey Diller stands at his 32. Fantastic kick. Perez and Diller takes a fair catch at nearly the 27. Quarterfinal play continues tomorrow. North Dakota State, the number one seed and defending national champs, take on Wofford at home. Old Dominion is home against Georgia Southern. And still to come, Eastern Washington and Illinois State tomorrow on ESPN3 at 6 o'clock. The winner there draws the winner tonight between the Bearcats and Bobcats.
Some nice matchup still to be played, and a lot of football still to be played in this game.
Venture to guess, without seeing the forecast for Eastern Washington, this may be the coldest game of the bunch.
Yes.
At least they get sunlight. Flanders picks up nine on first down. Joel Fuller with the stop. Flanders redshirted at Kansas State his freshman year. Transferred into Sam Houston State. What do you think of his game?
I think he has the entire package. I think he runs well in between the tackles. He protects the football. And he knows when there's 4 yards to be had on a play, he's not going to try to make it 24. He's a good north-south one-cut runner, and I think he fits this triple option package perfectly.
Second and one. Flanders again. First down and more as he takes it to the 40. And Timothy Flanders comes into this game with some extra motivation, and he's reminded every day, Allison.
Yeah, I'm sure he is, guys, especially when you consider last year. He really struggled against Montana State. They held him to just 38 yards. So this is a bit of a redemption performance for him, but really his goal is much bigger. He wants to get back to that national championship game and win it this time. Last year when they lost to North Dakota State, he stayed out on the field and watched them celebrate. Guys, he even has a picture of the national championship ring on his phone as motivation.
Now looking for his own ring and a quarterfinal victory for Sam Houston State. We go to the fourth in Bozeman, all Bearcats.
The craving for chocolate is all grown up. Ooh. Jared presents beautiful, natural Levion chocolate diamonds and chocolate cultured South Sea pearls. Levion is the only company on Earth to make jewelry with chocolate diamonds. Levion, the leading family in jewelry from ancient royalty to today's red carpet. You will only find these styles at Jared. Levion chocolate diamonds, they're anything but vanilla. That's why he went to Jared, the Galleria of Jewelry.
Where do you turn for legal matters? At LegalZoom, we've created a better place to handle your legal needs. Maybe you have questions about incorporating a business you'd like to start, or questions about protecting your family with a will or living trust, and you'd like to find the right attorney to help guide you along, answer any questions, and offer advice. With an A rating from the Better Business Bureau, LegalZoom helps you get personalized and affordable legal protection. In most states, a legal plan attorney is available with every personalized document to answer any questions. Get started at LegalZoom.com today, and now you're protected.
Sometimes life can be, well, a little uncomfortable. But when it's hard or hurts to go to the bathroom, there's Dulcolax Dual Softener. Dulcolax Dual Softener doesn't make you go, it just makes it easier to go. Dulcolax Dual Softener, make yourself comfortable.
Back at Bozeman, time to look at the game track. Sam Houston State took control in the second quarter with 17 unanswered points. Dominated time of possession in the second. Bell is now thrown for 200 and a couple of touchdowns, and it turned two takeaways into 10 points.
Yeah, Brian Bell's been able to hit the big play when this offense needed it.
Flanders. Nope, Bell with the option pitch to Sincere, and he gets wrapped up. Forward progress to the 44, Joel Fuller with the stop. One of the things you and I talked about today when it comes to defending the option is that it is better the more people you get involved.
Absolutely. And this defense for Montana State, they practiced 2 days without even using the football so they could get their fits right. No matter where the football is going to end up in this triple option, you have to respect what your job is and your lane and your run fit. So this defense has done a decent job of it, but too many big plays by Timothy Flanders and Brian Bell and Richard Sincere. Too much speed right now for Montana State.
Flanders still motoring and tripped up from behind. They faced the option once this season, but it was different. Portland State runs a pistol option, just quarterback and pitch.
Yeah, and they didn't face a guy that could run it when there's not a whole lot of running room. Timothy Flanders is able to make himself small and then be able to squeeze his body to the second level. And they've been able to spread the football around, Tom, and get all their playmakers involved.
111 yards tonight for Flanders, ninth 100-yard game of the season. In the 13th game of the season for Sam Houston State. Flanders hit in the backfield, and he gets taken down for a loss of a couple. Zach Minter was the first man in. Brad Daly cleaned it up. Daly cleaned up the win last week against Stony Brook. A sack on the last two plays and a fumble recovery, and he was working against the right tackle who goes 6'8", 345. He said after the game, that's the biggest man I've ever seen in my life. And they got those tackles for loss out of their base defense with just the front four. The front four hasn't been as effective tonight against primarily a rushing team. Second and 13. Flanders again hitting the backfield. Alex Singleton coming up big in place of the injured Jody Owens.
And that's the way you disrupt a triple option. You have to play in the offensive backfield. It was Brad Daly on the first play, and now it's Alex Singleton. He does such a nice job from this position of getting into the backfield. Watch him just scrape down and be able to get around the block, get to the point of where Timothy Flanders is going, and then make a nice open field tackle. That's just a terrific job by a sophomore linebacker.
Owens on the left. Big Sky defensive MVP out for the rest of the game. Caught over the middle. Chance Nelson takes it in. Another big strike over the middle from Brian Bell. And this one goes for 45. Second touchdown grab for Chance Nelson. Just when you think you've got momentum, the Bearcats strike again.
And Brian Bell has been on the mark when he needed to. It looked like Joel Fuller just fell down. Watch five in the back. He just falls down. And that allows a wide open Chance Nelson. That's his responsibility. It looked like he just got tangled up around the hash mark. And Chance Nelson just ran right by him.
34-9, Sam Houston State trying to work its way to the semifinals. Brian Bell to Chance Nelson for the second time tonight. Now we're only waiting on snow.
The holidays are here, and that means falling prices at Rent-A-Center. Right now, get a Samsung 43-inch plasma TV or a 5-piece bedroom set. Your choice, just $780. And with the Rack Flex plan, everyone's pre-approved for 90 days, same as cash.
Travels towards an intersection with wipers that streak and clog, while another travels towards the same intersection with wiper blades that don't let them see clearly. But between them, the Michelin Man with new Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades. A revolution in wiper blade technology, combining SmartFlex construction for superior windshield contact with proven hybrid blade design for clog-free performance in rain, ice, and snow, helping you steer clear for the road ahead. New Michelin Stealth Wiper Blades, a better way forward.
To win the Capital One Cup and be the best in men's and women's college sports, you're gonna lay it all on the line. Every play, every game, in every sport. Teams are battling it out for NCAA Division I championships, $400,000 in student-athlete scholarships, and the Capital One Cup trophy. More metal for the case. Follow your school and check the standings at CapitalOneCup.com to see who will win the Capital One Cup.
Little throwback. Here's McNorth. He's got a ton of room. Down to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Bison. North Dakota State wins the Division I football championship.
Frisco's the place to be. And that was the only loss of the season last year for the Bearcats of Sam Houston State. Another look at the Bearcats' last touchdown.
Well, Chance Nelson's going to be in the slot here. And Fuller's the safety to that side. You're going to watch this route. It's really like a skinny post, but I think that Fuller thought Chance Nelson was going to go to the corner right here, and he gets his body going one way, and I think his legs just got tangled up because Chance Nelson is wide open down the middle of the field. And the only thing you could think of is that Fuller was trying to guess the route or jump the route to the outside, but Chance Nelson had other ideas. He was going to the skinny post for six.
Couple of touchdown passes for Brian Bell tonight. Both to Nelson and the one, Sean Johnson. What do you think Brian Bell's mom would say about that skinny post?
I think she likes it. I think she's going to get Willie Fritz on the bat line. Said, call that one again.
Always work the skinny post against the two deep?
Absolutely. It's one of the places you can afford to go. And I believe that Joel Fuller thought the other place is the corner. So they've run so much smash route, which means the outside receiver is going to run a 5-yard route and kind of hang down low where you have a corner behind it. But Brian Bell was able to keep his eyes down the field and find Chance Nelson. Brian's having a nice evening here in Montana.
23 yards per completion tonight for Bell. Denarius McGee lets one go outside, complete grab by John Ellis. 12 minutes to go in this game. Montana State doesn't have any time to waste. They were effective in their first drive in the second half, going no huddle, and they'll try to do it again.
False start. That'll back up the Bobcats.
False start. Offense, number 55. 5-yard penalty, still second down.
Well, Sam Houston State defensively deserves a lot of credit tonight for what they've done against Denarius McGee and Montana State.
Well, they do it with speed and tenacity. Beauchamp on the outside, we've called his name a number of times, coming off a huge game last week. And then the Taylor brothers, one at linebacker and one at safety. They play so well and so much downhill tackling in space. They've done a nice job, and now pressuring the pocket.
And McGee gets thrown for a loss by Gary Lawrence. It's his fourth sack of the season. And for more on the Taylor brothers, the twins on the defensive side of the ball, here's Allison.
Yeah, the twins, a couple of seniors wanting to make sure this is not their last game playing together. They have played together their entire lives, and initially they did not receive any D1 offers. 2 weeks before signing day, Sam Houston State gave them a call, offered them scholarships, and they jumped at the chance to continue playing together.
Third and long, incomplete. Thanks, Allison. And Darnell, we understand, shaved his head coming into this game. So Darnell's got a little bit of a rat tail off the back. Darius still has the long locks. So for the first time since the seniors have been on campus, you can tell them apart.
You can say, hey, Darnell, how you doing? Feel confident about it.
Instead of, hey, Mr. Taylor.
That's right.
The first set of twins to be named all-conference in school history. And Darnell last year had 128 tackles, the most in school history since the late 80s. Back that up with now nearing on 100 tackles this season. Fourth and 19, 11 minutes left in the season. Do you have to punt it away?
Well, Tom, you don't want to give the football back inside the 10-yard line.
There's some extra pushing and shoving. And it continues, and this is something you want to avoid, especially if you're the winner and you don't want to get suspended for the next game, that's for sure. Looks like Melvis Pride was in on the action for Sam Houston State. Emotions running high here in Bozeman as the 3-seed Montana State is on the ropes in the fourth quarter.
Be fine.
More people are leaving BMW, Mercedes, and Lexus for Audi than ever before. Take advantage of exceptional values during the Season of Audi event.
If you've ever waded through a sea of tools looking for the right wrench, check this out. Craftsman Universal, innovation that lets you do more with fewer tools. Notice the universal tooth design. It handles 6 different types of fasteners: hex, 12-point, square, external torx, spline, and partially rounded hex. The black matte finish and high contrast markings make it easy to grab the right tool for the job. One set of tools, all types of fasteners, every kind of job. Plus, they're backed by the Craftsman Lifetime Guarantee. These just might become your favorite tools. Right now, the 56-piece set is priced at just $79.99. Now, also available, the 19-piece Universal Max Access set with pass-through design, just $39.99. It goes where standard and deep sockets can't. Smaller sets starting at just $12.99. So hurry into Sears. Visit us online at sears.com/innovation or call to take advantage of these great deals. Craftsman, guys' favorites, guaranteed.
What a weekend in college football. The most revered award in college football will be presented Saturday on ESPN. Who will join one of the game's most exclusive fraternities? The Heisman Trophy presentation, Saturday at 8 on ESPN. Johnny Manziel, the freshman from Texas A&M, built his resume on the strength of SEC play, but he also had a chance to do so against these Bearcats. Threw for 267 yards, 3 touchdowns, ran for another 100, and 2 more scores in just over a half as Texas A&M beat Sam Houston State 47-28, last regular season game of the season. There are some changes in the Southland Conference, a couple of teams left, and so Sam Houston State had to scramble to fill out their schedule. Texas A&M was the only team that had an open date to close the regular season, and that's how the Bearcats got matched up with the Aggies at Kyle Field. There's Flanders once again. And look at the numbers the freshman has put up this season.
He's had an amazing year for a young quarterback. And you take a look at two other Heisman Trophy winners, and he blows Tim Tebow's numbers away from 07 and comparable to Cam Newton, but still well above that. So Johnny Manziel has every right to feel like he could put his one hand on that Heisman Trophy because of the success he's had in the competition that he's played against.
Not bad for a guy who was unknown during two of those. Flanders. Just back to the line of scrimmage. Noah Moyakiola with the stop for the Bobcats.
Defense still playing with pride, even though they're down 34-9. It's a team that had every right to feel coming into this game they could hang with Sam Houston State defensively. I think Sam Houston State end up getting a couple good bounces and taking advantage of big plays to run the score to 34-9.
Fumbled the ball four times, never lost it. Keyshawn Hill in a running back. He might be a forgotten man. He finished seventh in the conference in rushing this season. Hill escapes one man, escapes another. Two more finally bring him down. James Andrews, another Texan on the Montana State side, brings him down. Senior from Rockwall, Texas. And fourth down here for the Bearcats of Sam Houston State. 34-9 is the lead, and the offense stays on the field.
And Tom, you think about the Bearcats, and offensively, you say triple option, but the improvement of Brian Bell being able to throw the football makes this team so dangerous because you just can't focus in on Timothy Flanders and Richard Sinier. You have to pay attention and affect the pocket defensively if you're going to stop or slow down this offense.
254 yards passing and three touchdowns tonight for Brian Bell. Matt Foster, the Australian, gets it away. And Sean Johnson nearly let that fair catch get away from him. Montana State running out of time with 8:17 to go in the fourth.
What can you experience in a seat? Inspiration. Great power. Iconic design. Exhilarating performance.
Once again has created Lamar history.
And once in a great while, all of the above. Take your seat in the incomparable Audi A8. Take advantage of exceptional values on the Audi A8 during the Season of Audi event. Of course, the holidays are about giving. But we all remember the one gift. The one we wrote letters asking for and finished all our vegetables for. Save big on great gifts at Bass Pro Shops' Countdown to Christmas sale. Like select Redhead flannel and Henley shirts for under $20. This Wii Game Mega Pack with controllers for under $40. And this Bass Pro Aluminum Fish Fryer for under $40. Plus, kids can get a free picture with Santa. That's right, free.
Introducing Droid DNA by HTC. It's not an upgrade to your phone. It's an upgrade to yourself.
The NCAA FCS Football Championship is presented by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. We'll pick you up. Hey, great skiing in Big Sky Country. The Bridger's open today. Big Sky Ski Resort open Thanksgiving. And the Snow Coach Tours in Yellowstone start December 15th. If you want to
come
stick
on back.
Around. Yeah,
yep.
Come back next week.
You'll be back out here this
Boise,
area, right?
Yeah, Boise's pretty close.
Yeah.
We're going to miss you next week.
I know it.
You're going to miss those freaking flyer miles.
That's right. I already counted that at the beginning of the year.
34-9. Sam Houston State in control. Denarius McGee with great blocking up front. Has all day to think about it. Into coverage. What a grab! A one-hand haul. Pass. past midfield. Tanner Bleskin with the play of the night.
What a catch by Tanner Bleskin. This is just a chuck from Denarius McGee. He's just trying to get it close. And Taylor can't make a play on the football. That's just an outstanding effort by Bleskin. The one hand, the left hand, he reaches out, takes the football away. And the Bobcats have the football on the Bearcats side of the 50.
Andrew Weaver is the injured Bearcat. The coaches told us that they want Denarius McGee to take calculated risks based on uncertainty. Meaning, if you're not certain of making a play, don't make it. But if you know what the risks are, it's kind of like pulling out the three wood on a par five. If you know what the risks are and you want to haul off, go for it.
You know what, Tom? With 8:07 left to go in this game and your season looks like it's not going to continue next week, you have to take risk. You have to be able to push the envelope down the field and count on players like Tanner Bleskin to make plays for you. Denarius is in the pocket. He's just trying to make a play. He's looking for another blue jersey. And he says, you know what? I got to give him an opportunity to go up and make a play. And that's what Bleskin did, the junior wideout. He has good size at 6'3". He high points the football and makes a terrific one-handed catch.
Junior out of Great Falls, Montana, C.M. Russell High School. Here comes a blitz straight up the middle again. McGee, great coverage. Downfield, caught! Inside the 10 is Flatketter. The offensive line's giving McGee time to throw.
And that's the key to back-to-back chunk yardage plays down the field. McGee has time to sit in the pocket and let his receivers that were covered initially break off of their routes and make a play down the field.
Oh, yeah!
Back-to-back 43-yard plays from Denarius McGee. First and goal now for Montana State.
And now you run the quarterback.
Pressure from the corners. He tucked it and get thrown for a loss. The Taylor brothers in on the stop. Darnell and Darius.
You get in this red zone, and Sam Houston State has so much speed. You want to be able to spread them out and give McGee at quarterback an opportunity to run or throw the football. If he finds a crease, let him tuck it in and try to get it with his legs.
Bearcats won't stop bringing pressure. McGee goes down. Darius Taylor again, his sixth sack of the season.
Well, Denarius needs to understand when Sam Houston State is in zero coverage and they're bringing one more than you can block, you can't hang on to the football that long. If you don't like it early, you throw it out of the back of the end zone. You don't want to take a sack down here because the clock's going to continue to run. Just go ahead and try to get rid of it because that pressure is hot right now in that offensive backfield.
Fifth sack of the night for Sam Houston State. Third and goal from the 17. No pressure that time. McGee took off and a well-defended play. JT Cleveland with the stop. I think they ran the quarterback draw expecting another blitz.
Well, they did, but the key was to run it after that consecutive 43-yard gain. That was the time to run the quarterback draw, not when you after you take a sack and you really have to go almost 20 yards for the touchdown.
Fourth and goal, Montana State will go for it.
Pick your best matchup man-to-man and go for it.
Touchdown, John Ellis.
Nice throw by Denarius McGee to the short side of the field. All John Ellis did was run that slant. He got inside of the defender, Dak Swanson, at the bottom of the top of the screen. He was able to get inside of the pressure and put his body in a good spot to make that catch.
2:52 off the clock on the drive, 5:25 left in regulation for Bozeman. Two huge plays from Denarius McGee. Tanner Bleskin with the circus catch for a 43-yard pickup. And they go right back to the air again. This time it's Flotketter. And it set up this touchdown strike from McGee to Ellis.
To win the Capital One Cup and be the best in men's and women's college sports, you gotta lay it all on the line. Every play, every game, in every sport. Teams are battling it out for NCAA Division I championships, $400,000 in student-athlete scholarships, and the Capital One Cup trophy. More metal for the case. Follow your school and check the standings at CapitalOneCup.com to see who will win the Capital One Cup.
Be one with it, and it will be one with you. Be one with your tires, and the road will be one with you. Hankook Tires.
I have a cold. I took DayQuil, but I still have a runny nose.
DayQuil doesn't treat that.
Huh?
Alka-Seltzer Plus rushes relief to all your worst cold symptoms, plus it relieves your runny nose.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Right. That's the cold truth.
Tell us how much garland you used to decorate your home last Christmas.
Around the fireplace.
I have no idea.
Going up the stairs.
How do you figure that out?
Spools and spools.
Right. We don't know exactly how much garland.
Don't worry, My Lowe's automatically tracks and stores all of your Lowe's purchases so you can get that same great look again this year.
Wonderful. It is awesome.
Yay!
We scan, My Lowe's remembers. Your life gets easier. My Lowe's. Sign up in your Lowe's store today. Lowe's, never stop improving.
You don't have a home. It was taken from you. But I will help you take it back if I can.
On December 14th, see the journey that started it all. From the director of the Lord of the Rings trilogy, The Hobbit, An Unexpected Journey. Rated PG-13. In theaters December 14th.
Are starting with Sam Houston State leading Montana State 34-16. 5:25 left and a scoring drive led by Denarius McGee. Six plays, 91 yards all through the air. 2:52 off the clock and Ellis with the touchdown catch. Sports Center's coming up as soon as we're finished here. If you want to catch it now, you can flip over to ESPN News.
That last scoring drive seems to get some of the fans excited. But they need a little bit more with 5:25 left to go.
Little pooch on the outside attempt, and it's covered at the 39-yard line by Dak Swanson. That's okay. He'll stay warm because he's keeping his head covered.
That's right.
Here's a look at our brackets. Don't forget tomorrow, 4-seed Old Dominion will be home in Norfolk, Virginia against the 5-seed Georgia
Please
Southern
set the game
at noon
clock.
On ESPN. North Dakota State takes on Wofford on ESPN 3 at 3. And Eastern Washington is home against Illinois State, 6 o'clock Eastern on ESPN 3. Illinois State at large out of the Missouri Valley Conference. Here comes that winter weather. Brian Bell on the sideline for now. Richard Sincere in at quarterback. Sincere will keep it, and he gets ridden to the ground by Na'a Moyakiola. No gain.
Well, now it's all about, for the Bearcats, just staying in bounds and trying to run this clock down. The Bobcats have all three timeouts remaining. So I'm sure they need another stop here on second down, and Willie Fritz on the Bearcat sideline just wants to keep milking this clock down. Take it down, snap the football inside of 5 seconds for Brian Bell.
On second and 10, pitch
to Keyshawn Hill. So with a win tonight, Sam Houston State will advance to the semis Keyshawn for the Hill second straight around. Season. Last year they had to go through the Montana schools to get there. The favorites to wait for them would be Eastern Washington, tied for the Southland Conference title with, or pardon me, tied with Montana State for the Big Sky title, but held the tiebreaker over the Bobcats. If you're going to be home on the red turf.
Well, Tom, if you're going to beat Sam Houston State, you're going to have to stop number 11, because he's been able to dish the football in this triple option. He's been able to beat this team in Montana State throwing the football.
They wanted to bring the pressure on third and two. Zach Minner may not have been the only one who crossed the line.
Offsides, defense, number 96, 5-yard penalty. That gives us a first down.
Three timeouts remain for the Bobcats of Montana State. For the second straight season, it seems like their year is going to end at the hands of the Bearcats.
And Tom, isn't it always about matchups? The way you match up your team against the opposition, it just seems like Sam Houston State has a couple more athletes, a little bit more speed than Montana State.
Hill, into the pile on first down. Sure. 2012 NCAA Division I football championship continues next weekend with semifinal games on December 14th and 15th. Both games will be on the ESPN networks. For more information, go to NCAA.com, the official online home for all 89 NCAA championships. FCS field will expand next season to 24 with 11 conferences that participate in the postseason. One more automatic berth and three more at-large berths will be available. Straight ahead, Keyshawn Hill, sophomore at Klein High School. Pickup of 13.
And really, Keyshawn's been the guy that's been quiet for Sam Houston State on the offensive side. It's been more of Timothy Flanders and Richard Sincere who's been getting those yards on the ground. Flanders does get over 100 yards at 106 on 31 attempts, and the rushing yards as a team just favoring the Bearcats.
Ground game proved to be the difference tonight for Sam Houston State. Montana State had a short week to prepare for their option attack. Ridgeway Frank, first carry of the night, nothing doing. Montana State has been in the top 10 for 27 straight weeks. Three consecutive Big Sky titles, matching a team from the late 60s to the best string in school history. And they've done it versus the run. They've held Stony Brook to 150 yards below their season average, and four times this season held their opponents to under 60 yards. That was not the case tonight. Sports Center coming up next. 140 to go in Bozeman. Frank again, second straight carry. Well, the Bearcats started their weekend with a snowball fight at the team hotel as soon as they landed here in Bozeman. And they'll end it with a fun flight home.
Well, they came out fighting tonight. Sam Houston State firing on all cylinders offensively. Big night for Trey Diller, the receiver for the Bearcats. He was able to have three catches for 104 yards in that long of 56 for a touchdown. And Brian Bell was the story. 11 of 21 for 254 and three big touchdowns on the evening.
Frank stood up on third down by Joel Fuller and company. This will be the third straight week Montana State will score 16 points. They won the first two thanks to some takeaways, but in offense, it was seventh in the nation in scoring, held to just 16 again tonight.
And head coach Rob Ash knew at halftime he needed to change something up. He knew the team speed of Sam Houston State might have been a little bit overwhelming in that first half, so he wanted to come out and attack, and they faked a punt, tried to get into the game, couple big plays, but come up a little short here in the quarterfinals.
Bell will run out the clock and take a knee. A school record 29 wins as a starter at Sam Houston State. If you can make it to 31, they'll be national champs. 34-16, Sam Houston State comes to the cold in the Big Sky Country and comes away a winner. Flanders and Company with a 34-16 victory.